So good evening. How do you say?
Takže dobrý večer.
How do you say good evening?
Dobrý večer.
Dobrý deče. It's not bad.
To není zlé.
Jedna, dvě, tři, čtyři, pět, šest, sedm, osm, devět, deset. My mom is actually from Czech.
Moje maminka vlastně pochází z Čech.
And when we were children,
keď jsme byli malé děti,
she said, "You need to learn Czech."
Hovorila mi, máte se učit česky.
But we didn't have any contact with our relatives in Czech.
Ale nemali jsme žádný kontakt s našimi příbuznými v Čechách.
So we said, "Mom, everybody in Germany speaks German. Why do we need to learn Czech?"
A my jsme jí povedali, maminka, nač se máme učit po česky, keď všetci v Německu hovoria po německy.
And I didn't learn it.
A tak jsem se neučil.
My mom was right.
Ale moje mama mala pravdu.
I would be happy, I would have listened to her.
Byl by som teraz rád, keby som ju bol vtedy počúval.
But I'm really so touched that I can be here in the nation where my mom comes from.
Ale dnes som tak dotknutý tým, že môžem byť naspäť v národe, odkiaľ moja maminka pochádza.
I've been few times before in Czech and in Slovakia.
Bol som v Čechách aj na Slovensku už niekoľkokrát predtým.
And I could always feel that a part of me belongs there.
A vždy som akoby vnímal, že som súčasťou.
And I guess I have a lot of relatives in Czech.
Myslím, že mám veľa príbuzných v Čechách.
Because my mom's family, there were 12 children.
Pretože v rodine mojej maminky bolo 12 detí.
And they're coming from a place called, in German it's called Königsgrätz.
A po nemecky sa to mesto, odkiaľ maminka pochádza, nazýva
Königs. You know,
Hradec Králové.
Yeah. And when I tell people in Czech this story,
a keď ľuďom v Čechách rozprávam ten príbeh,
they always say, "We bring you in television. There is a show where they find your relatives." You know, they say, "We will bring you in the television show where they look for your relatives."
Tak oni mi povedia, tak my vás pozveme do takej TV show, kde oni nájdu tých vašich príbuzných.
But I really want to come. I really want to come this year in the summer with my children and have a look around if we find some.
Ale toto leto by som naozaj rád prišiel sem aj so svojimi deťmi, ak by sme našli nejaké miesto.
Now you might say,
teraz môžete povedať,
"I thought you are a prophet, you should find them."
My sme si mysleli, že si prorok, mal by si ich sám nájsť.
You should know everything.
Mal by si vedieť všetko.
No, we don't know so much as you think.
Ale my nevieme až toľko, ako si vymyslíte.
But sometimes we know more than you think.
Ale niekedy vieme viac, než si myslíte.
You know, who has never experienced the prophetic?
Kto ešte z vás nikdy nezažil niečo prorocké?
Who has experienced it but not in a good way?
A kto z vás to zažil, ale nie dobrým spôsobom?
Be honest.
Buďte úprimní.
We will not tell your pastor.
Nepovieme to vášmu pastorovi.
So be honest.
Takže môžete byť úprimní, slobodní.
So I want to say sorry to you if you experienced it in a not good way.
Chcem vám povedať, odpuste, prepáčte, ak ste to tak zažili.
You know what the funny thing is?
Viete, čo je sranda?
If someone ministers in healing,
ak niekto slúži uzdravením,
and he prays for 10 people,
a modlí sa za 10 ľudí,
and one person gets healed,
a iba jeden z nich je uzdravený,
everyone speaks about this one person.
Všetci budú hovoriť o tom jednom.
But if you minister in the prophetic,
ale ak slúžite prorocky,
and you minister to 10 people,
a slúžite 10 ľuďom,
and with 9 you are spot on, you're spot on, you're right.
Ale ak v tých deviatich ste presní.
And with one person you miss it a little bit.
A pri tom jednom sa trošku pomýlite, seknete.
Everyone speaks about this one person.
Tak každý budem hovoriť o tej jednej osobe.
Yeah, that's the strange thing.
To je zvláštna vec.
I'm totally aware, you know, that there have been mistakes.
Takže som si úplne jasné, že poznáte naše chyby.
And I never was God asking for this ministry.
Ja som nikdy Boha neprosil o túto službu.
I even didn't know that in church there is something like this.
Ani som nevedel, že v cirkvi také niečo je.
My mother came from a Catholic background.
Moja maminka pochádza z katolického pozadia.
And when I was a teenager, I walked away from church.
A keď som bol teenager, tak som z cirkvi odišiel.
Because what I experienced there was not real for me.
Pretože to, čo som tam zažil, pre mňa nebolo skutočné.
It didn't give me anything for me as a young person.
Pre mňa ako mladého človeka to nič nedalo.
And I was carrying a lot of pain in me.
A nesiel som veľa bolesti.
Because of rejection what I experienced in my life.
Kvôli odmietnutiu, ktoré som zakúsil v mojom živote.
My mother married a German man.
Moja mama sa vydala za Nemca.
After the war they left Czech.
A po vojne odišli z Čech.
So she was somehow rejected by her nation by people because she was married with a German.
Takže určitým spôsobom ju odmietli českí ľudia kvôli tomu, že si vzala Nemca.
And after the war this was not a good thing to be married to a German.
Po vojne to nebola tá najlepšia vec vziať si Nemca.
And in Germany she was rejected because she was not a German.
A v Nemecku ju zase odmietali, pretože nebola Nemka.
So she was very lonely.
Takže ona bola veľmi osamelá.
And I heard her very often cry.
A veľmi často som ju počul plakať.
And her greatest wish was always to come one time back to her nation.
A jej najväčšou túžbou bolo vrátiť sa raz naspäť do Čiech.
My German stepfather, her German husband.
Jej nemecký manžel.
He was full of pain.
Bol plný bolesti.
And he was a violent man.
A bol to násilný človek.
And he had another relationship.
Mal iný vzťah.
And my mother in her pain.
A moja maminka v jej bolesti.
She met an Italian man.
V tom čase stretla talianského muža, Taliana.
And it happened me.
A tak som sa stal ja.
Italian nose.
Talianský nos.
You know, bold.
Plešatý.
Temper.
Temperamentný.
Everything from the Italian side is a little bit stronger than the Czech, sorry.
Všetko proste z tej talianskej stránky je vo mne silnejšie ako z tej českej.
I still try to discover the Czech side in me.
Stále sa snažím nájsť, objaviť v sebe tú českú stránku.
But I feel there is something.
Ale cítim, že tam niečo je.
So my stepfather, the German father,
takže ten môj nemecký otčím,
hated me from the moment when he knew that my mother is pregnant from another man.
Ma nenávidel od toho momentu, ako zistil, že moja maminka ma čaká.
And he tried to kill her, to kill me.
Snažil sa ma zabiť.
By kicking her in her womb when she was pregnant with me.
Takže ju proste v tehotenstve kopal do brucha.
And so when I was born,
takže keď som sa narodil,
I was the living reminder on the pain he experienced by this thing what happened.
Že ja som bol vlastne taká živá pripomienka toho, čo sa stalo v tom jej druhom vzťahu.
So he hated me.
Takže ma nenávidel.
He called me bastard.
A nazýval ma bastard.
And he was beating me.
A bil ma.
And so when you receive pain, you will give pain to others.
Keď sám príjmete bolesť, tak budete dávať bolesť.
The Bible says we love because he loved us first.
Biblia hovorí, že my milujeme preto, že on nás prvý miloval.
You know, as a child, if you grow up in something like this,
a keď ako dieťa v takomto niečom vyrastáte,
you try to survive.
Snažíte sa prežiť.
You try to be good.
Snažíte sa byť dobrý.
But then you have a lot of questions to God if he is there.
Ale budete mať veľa otázok k Bohu, ak je tam nejaký.
Why did he allow this?
Prečo to dovolil?
Why I'm born in this family?
Prečo som sa narodil do tejto rodiny?
In German society, we were a poor family.
V nemeckej spoločnosti my sme boli chudobná rodina.
My mother was always making soup, hoping that we already full from the soup, so we don't need to eat so much more.
Maminka často robila polievku, lebo dúfala, že z tej polievky sa nasytíme.
And I remember she was always doing a kind of dampfnudeln from Czech, she learned this, knödel mit Pflaumen drin and things like this.
Robila do toho nejakú závarku, nejaké nudličky. Nudle, knedlíky.
Yeah, and the sugar over it and
aha, tak ešte okrem toho proste nejaké knedlíky a pocukrila to.
But we never had enough.
Ale nikdy sme nemali dosť.
And so I was rejected in school.
Takisto som ma odmietali v škole.
Because I was coming from this poor family.
Pretože som pochádzal z tej chudobnej rodiny.
And I got punched and called stupid and everything.
A proste mi robili zlé a bol som hlúpy a
The problem is.
Problém je.
If there's no one who tells you the truth, you start to believe that there's something wrong with you.
Že ak vám niekto nepovie pravdu, tak začnete veriť tomu, že je s vami niečo zlé.
And the same way I hated my father, my stepfather.
Takisto som nenávidel svojho otčima.
My real father I never met, he went back to Italy.
Mojho skutočného otca som nikdy nepoznal, on odišiel do Talianska.
And when my mom, and I didn't even know till I was in my teenage that my real father is Italian. My mom didn't tell me.
Ja som sa to vlastne nedozvedel až do mojho mladistvého veku, že vlastne môj otec skutočný je v Taliansku.
And when she told me when I was in my teenage,
keď mi to v tom čase povedali,
I was so disappointed.
Keď som dospieval, bol som z toho zničený.
I felt my mother is the only person I can trust and she has lied to me.
Z toho, že vlastne jediná osoba, ktorej som dôveroval, ktorá bola moja maminka, mi vlastne klamala.
But I know she did it to protect me.
ale viem, že to robila kvôli tomu, aby ma ochránila.
But then I understood why my father called me bastard and was hating me.
Ale až vtedy som porozumel, prečo ma vlastne ten otec nenávidel a nazýval ma bastardom.
So when I decided as a teenager I will not more trust anyone.
Takže ako teenager som sa rozhodol, že nebudem už nikomu dôverovať.
And God is not real.
A Boh nie je skutočný.
If he is real, he is quite a bad guy.
A ak je skutočný, tak je veľmi zlý.
Because it's his fault that I'm born in this family.
Pretože je to jeho vina, že som sa narodil do tejto rodiny.
When I was a child, when I was young.
Keď som bol dieťa.
In the first few years.
Prvých pár rokov.
My stepfather came in the night in the room and tried to sophisticate me with a cushion.
Môj otčím sa snažil, proste prišiel do mojej izby a snažil sa ma zadusiť nejakou vreckovkou.
So I was constantly in fear in the night.
Takže ja som v noci žil neustále v strachu.
But you know what was strange?
Ale bolo to niečo zvláštne.
I had dreams and they happened.
Mával som sny, ktoré sa potom naplnili.
And sometimes I knew things.
A niekedy som akoby vedel veci.
And sometimes I felt that someone good is there.
Alebo som niekedy cítil, že niečo je dobré, alebo niekto dobrý. Niečo, čo som nevidel.
But sometimes I also felt something evil is there.
Ale takisto som vnímal aj zlé veci.
But I had no idea what this is.
Ale netušil som, čo to je.
Later, when the Lord called me,
neskôr, keď ma Pán povolal,
he said to me, Jeremiah 1, I have called you from your mother's womb on as a prophet.
Prehovoril ku mne z Jeremiáša, ja som ťa povolal už v živote tvojej matky ako proroka.
I mean, when God called me, I even didn't know what a prophet is.
A keď som dostal to povolanie, ešte som ani nevedel, kto to je prorok.
I thought it's this guy from the Old Testament.
Myslel som, že to je ten chlapík z toho starého zákona.
Who come and bring you good news, a bad news.
Ktorý prichádza a prináša zlé správy.
I mean, you know the story of where the children called the prophet Boldhead, bold guy, you know.
Poznáte ten príbeh, ako tie detičky sa vysmievali tomu plešivému prorokovi.
And they get killed by wild animals.
A proste boli zabité tými medveďmi.
This is strange.
To je divné.
You know, but I didn't know that there is also something in the New Testament about it.
Ale netušil som, že je o tom niečo aj v Novom zákone.
To shorten the story, I
skrátiť ten príbeh.
In my teenage, I became one of the leaders of a gang called Red Devils.
Takže keď som dospieval, stal som sa lídrom nejakého gengu, ktorý sa volal Červení diabli.
And my life was full of violence and hatred.
Môj život bol plný nenávisti a násilia.
And I hated myself more and more.
A nenávidel som samého seba viac a viac.
Because I became a person I never wanted to be.
Pretože som sa stal niekým, kým som nikdy nechcel byť.
I became worse than my stepfather.
Stal som sa horším, ako bol môj otčím.
And so I tried to push this pain down by drinking and taking drugs.
A tak som sa snažil potlačiť tú bolesť tým, že som pil a bral drogy.
And I became someone who I'm not.
A stal som sa niekým, kým v skutočnosti nie som.
I opened my life for the occult side.
Otvoril som svoj život okultizmu.
And I got in contact with spirits.
A dostal som sa do kontaktu s duchmi.
Because you know what the prophetic gift is.
Pretože viete, čo to je prorocký dar?
The prophetic gift is the ability in you to connect with the spiritual world.
Pretože prorocký dar je vlastne schopnosť vo vás byť spojený s duchovným svetom.
And if the Lord is not in control over your life,
a ak Pán nemá váš život pod kontrolou,
you still can connect with the spiritual world.
Tak vy ste schopní kontaktovať sa s duchovným svetom.
But you get deceived.
Ale budete oklamaní.
It's like a radio, you're on the wrong frequency.
Je to ako keby ste boli na rádiu na zlej frekvencii.
And to use the gift in the right way, you need to be in relationship with God through Jesus.
A na to, aby ste mohli tento dar správne používať, musíte byť v vzťahu s Bohom skrze Pána Ježiša Krista.
And the word of God and the Holy Spirit are the navigation system for the spiritual world.
A Božie slovo a Duch Svätý je ako navigačný systém v tomto svete, pre orientáciu v tomto svete.
But I didn't know these things.
Ale toto som netušil.
Because in the beginning these spirits they were quite nice.
Pretože na začiatku títo duchovia boli celkom milí.
I went to fortune tellers.
Chodil som k jasnovidcom.
And they had pictures of Jesus and Mary in their place.
Mali v miestnosti obrázky Márie, Ježiša.
And I thought it can't be wrong.
Tak som si myslel, to nemôže byť zlé.
They're quite religious.
Oni sú takí nábožní.
But I sensed something is wrong.
Ale vnímal som, že niečo je zlé.
But I was also fascinated from this unknown world.
Ale takisto ma tento neznámy svet fascinoval.
You know, the problem is.
Viete, problém je?
What we need to understand as Christians.
Čo my potrebujeme ako kresťania rozumieť?
We serve a supernatural God.
Slúžime nadprirodzenému Bohu.
And he loves to communicate to us.
A on miluje s nami prostě komunikovat.
He himself is called the Word of God.
On sám se nazval slovem Božím.
And you know, and he started from the beginning of the world to communicate to us.
A on už na začátku světa s námi komunikoval.
He communicated through his son.
Komunikoval skrze svého syna.
And then Jesus says, and I'm not leaving you alone. I'm going now. And the Holy Spirit will come and he will continue to communicate.
A Ježíš potom povedal, ja odchádzam, ale nenechávam vás samých, ja vám pošlem Ducha Svätého, ktorý bude komunikovať s vami.
I say sometimes in a funny way.
Niekedy takým srandovným spôsobom hovorím.
I mean, he likes to talk so much that he calls himself the Word, the living Word.
Že on tak rád hovorí, že sa sám nazval živým slovom.
And it said
a povedal,
that we sometimes have more trust in the devil to deceive us than in the power of God to keep us and to protect us. Sometimes we have
niekedy,
more trust.
Niekedy viac dôverujeme tomu,
that the devil can deceive us when we ask God for a word.
Že diabol nás môže oklamať na to, aby sme poprosili Boha o slovo.
Then we trust God that he can communicate to us.
Než by sme dôverovali Bohu, ktorý chce s nami komunikovať.
I mean, he's God.
Ale on je Boh.
Some Christians know more about the devil than they know about their God.
Niektorí kresťania vedia viac o diablovi ako o Bohu.
I have met Christians that say, oh, this spirit is called this, this spirit is called this.
Stretol som kresťanov, ktorí povedali, tento duch je, sa volá takto a tento takto.
But when you ask him for the names of God,
ale keď sa ho pýtate na Božie mená,
they can say two, three names maybe.
Tak je dve alebo tri.
But they know 20 names of demons.
Ale pozná 20 mien démonov.
But they are not bad people.
Ale to nie sú zlí ľudia.
It's the power of religious spirits who have hijacked the people, have drawn their mind in somewhere else.
Ale je to proste moc náboženských duchov, ktoré odvádzajú myseľ ľudí na niečo iné.
So close to my 22nd birthday.
Takže blízko mojich 29. narodenín.
I decided I want to kill myself.
Tak som sa rozhodol, že sa zabijem.
I hated myself, I hated everyone.
Nenávidel som seba a všetkých.
I heard these voices.
Počul som hlasy.
Who were telling me kill yourself, kill yourself?
Ktoré mi hovorili zabij sa, zabij sa.
I saw these demonic faces.
Videl som demonické tváre.
But you know, I said to myself, but that's not real.
Ale ja som si hovoril, to nie je skutočné.
I must get crazy now. I'm getting crazy
asi
now.
Mi proste začína šibať.
Because the devil is an invention from the church to scare us. That's what I thought. The devil is an invention from the church.
Pretože diabol je akoby vynález cirkvi.
She's doing well, isn't she? Yeah. Ah, fantastic. You're doing well. Doing well.
Pretože ja som si myslel, že diabol je predsa vynález cirkvi, vymysel cirkvi.
It's not easy to translate me.
To nie je ľahké ma prekladať.
Because I have this German, English, whatever accent, you know.
Mám proste taký ten nemecko-anglický prízvuk.
My children, they are brought up in England. They say, what? What do you say?
Moje deti vyrastajú v Anglicku a nerozumejú mi.
I always invent new words for the English dictionary.
A ja vždy vymyslím nejaké nové slovo do anglického toho slovníka.
And if the English don't understand me?
A Angličania keď ma nerozumejú?
I say it's because I speak such a pure and high English, you know, because I'm so holy.
Tak ja poviem, že je to preto, lebo mám takú čistú a takú vznešenú angličtinu.
So she's doing really well.
Takže sa jej darí.
You know, the thing is, I didn't know that there was from my mother's womb on a father watching over me.
A ja som netušil, že od života mojej matky môj otec ma pozoroval.
And it would take many, many years more until I realized this.
A až trvalo veľa, veľa rokov, než som si na to prišiel, než som to zistil.
Because in the night when I tried to kill myself.
Pretože v tú noc, kedy som sa snažil zabiť.
And I saw that the devil is real.
A zistil som, že diabol je skutočný.
Something in my heart said, maybe God is real.
Niečo v mojom srdci povedalo, ale možno aj Boh je skutočný.
And I said something like this, God, if you are real.
A tak som povedal niečo takéto, Bože, ak si skutočný.
Do something now.
Urob niečo teraz.
And I experienced in this night.
A ja som v tú noc zažil.
And there was no Christian.
Nebol tam žiadny kresťan.
No charismatic Christian.
Žiadny charizmatický
no
kresťan.
No crazy Christian.
Žiadny bláznivý
no
kresťan.
No wild Christian.
Žiadny divoký kresťan.
No boring Christian.
Žiadny nudný kresťan.
There was no one there.
Nebol tam nikto.
And I experienced what the disciples experienced on Pentecost.
A ja som zažil niečo, čo učeníci zažili na deň letníc.
A strong wind came.
Prišiel silný vietor.
And a power came upon me which I've never experienced in my whole life.
A prišla na mňa moc, ktorú som nezažil nikdy v mojom živote.
I was covered like in a light, in the glory. I thought I'm dead.
Bol som proste odiatý v sláve a myslel som si, že som mŕtvy.
I thought I must have ended the nirvana or whatever they call it, you know.
Myslel som si, že som sa proste dostal do nejakej nirvány alebo čo.
And something happened.
Niečo sa stalo.
After this touch of God.
Po tomto dotyku Boha.
I had such a peace in my heart.
Prišiel pokoj do mojho srdca.
And before I had this voice in my head, kill yourself, kill yourself.
A predtým tie zvuky, hlasy, ktoré som počul, zabi sa.
This was gone.
To proste prešlo.
And I heard the first time in my life a gentle voice in my heart.
A prvýkrát v živote som počul tichý, príjemný hlas, jemný hlas v mojom vnútri.
And the voice said,
a ten hlas povedal,
you shall live.
Ty budeš žiť.
You shall live.
Ty budeš žiť.
One sentence.
Jedna veta.
Now I understand why the Bible says every word out of the mouth of God is powerful.
A teraz som porozumel, čo to znamená, že jedna jediná veta z Biblie je mocná.
One sentence of God can change your whole life.
Jedna jediná veta od Boha môže zmeniť váš život.
And I'm so happy.
A ja som tak rád, tak šťastný.
That I never heard a teaching, it's not possible that God speaks.
Že som nikdy nepočul vyučovanie na tému neverím, že Boh hovorí.
I even didn't know some real Christians.
Nepoznal som žiadnych skutočných kresťanov.
And after this experience I said, God,
a po tejto skúsenosti,
because now I had a new problem.
Som povedal, Bože, mám ďalší problém.
Which God was it?
Ktorý to bol Boh?
Because I know some people say it's Allah.
Pretože som počul, že sú je nejaký Allah.
Some pray to Buddha.
Nejaký Buddha.
Some say it's Krishna, Kavi, Hindu gods.
Niekto zase spomína nejaký Hindu a Krishna.
I didn't believe it's Jesus.
A ja som neveril, že je to Ježiš.
Because I tried Christianity as a child, it didn't work.
Pretože ako dieťa som kresťanstvo skúšal a nefungovalo to.
But I said, God, this must be you.
A ja som povedal, Bože, to musíš byť ty.
If you are real, show me the way.
Ak si skutočný, ukáž mi cestu.
And to make the story short.
Aby som to skrátil.
I'm here now today.
Som tu dnes.
And I'm here in the name of Jesus.
A som tu v mene Ježiš.
So it's not Krishna, it's not Allah, it's not Buddha.
Nie je to Krishna, nie je to Allah, nie je to Buddha.
His name is Jesus.
Jeho meno je Ježiš.
You know, and then I met some Christians.
A potom som stretol nejakých kresťanov.
And they told me about Jesus.
A oni mi povedali o Ježišovi.
And my mother had a heart attack and she was in the hospital in intensive care. She was going to die.
A moja maminka mala srdcový mala infarkt, skrátka bola na intenzívke práve vtedy.
And she was the one who tried to do everything for me. She spoiled me actually.
A ona je ten človek, ktorý sa snažila pre mňa urobiť všetko. Ona ma vlastne rozmaznala.
Because she wanted to protect me and she saw how I suffered.
Pretože ona sa ma snažila chrániť, pretože videla, ako trpím.
So I was scared.
Takže ja som bol, ja som sa zlakol.
What will happen when my mom is gone?
Čo urobím, keď moja maminka zomrie?
And now these Christians tell me, oh, Jesus can heal.
A títo kresťania mi hovorili, Ježiš vie uzdraviť.
And my Italian business side kicked in.
A moja talianska časť mozgu sa naštartovala.
This Jesus can heal.
Ježiš vie uzdraviť.
I'm doing a deal with him.
Tak ja sa s ním dohodnem.
If he heals my mother, he can have me.
Ak uzdraví moju maminku, môže mať mňa.
No, there was no, oh, this says the Lord, I'm a sinner. No, no.
Tam vôbec nebolo také, že toto hovorí pán, tak som hriešnik.
But you know, I know my father in heaven was sitting there and he was smiling.
Ale ja viem, že môj otec v nebesiach sedel a smial sa.
And he was saying, that's my boy.
A hovoril, to je môj chlapec.
You know, and he was saying, wait till I pour my goodness and my love in you.
Len počkaj, keď vylejem svoju dobrotu a lásku na teba.
You will be surprised what I'm doing with your life.
Budeš prekvapený, čo urobím v tvojom živote.
So I said to this guy, so what do I have to do that he heals my mom?
Tak som hovoril tým chlapcom, tak čo mám urobiť, aby uzdravil moju maminku?
And the people said, give your life Jesus.
A oni hovoria, tak daj Ježišovi svoj život.
Okay, I prayed the prayer of salvation.
Dobre, tak sa pomodlím tú modlitbu spasenia.
Then they said, you need the Holy Spirit.
A oni hovoria, potrebuješ Ducha Svätého.
And they said, Jesus has sent the Holy Spirit.
A oni hovoria, Ježiš poslal Ducha Svätého.
So that you can live the Christian life in his power.
Aby si mohol žiť kresťanský život v jeho sile.
And he will help you.
A on ti pomôže.
He will help you to understand the word of God.
On ti pomôže porozumieť Božiemu slovu.
He will help you to pray.
a pomohli mi modlit se.
And it's for free.
A bylo to zadarmo.
I heard the word free.
Já jsem počul to slovo zadarmo.
Free.
Zadarmo.
And I need it.
To jsem potřeboval.
Because I knew I can't be good on my own. I tried it.
Lebo já jsem věděl, že nevím se stát dobrým sám zo seba. Zkoušel jsem to.
After 10 minutes I failed.
Po 10 minutách jsem to vždycky zvoral.
And I said, okay.
Tak jsem povedal, okay.
They say he can heal my mother.
Sorry.
They say he can heal my mother.
Povedali, že uzdraví moju maminku.
And they say I get the Holy Spirit.
Povedali, že dostanem Ducha Svatého.
No idea what it is.
Nevím, čo to je.
But sounds good.
Ale znie to dobre.
Okay, what do I need to do?
Takže čo mám robiť?
And I said, pray with us and ask the Holy Spirit. The Bible says ask and God will give it to you.
Takže oni hovoria, tak pomodli sa, popros, aby Duch Svätý prišiel a v Biblii je napísané, že on príde.
And then?
Že Boh ti ho dá. A potom?
Oh, and then we start to pray in this new language, praying in tongues.
No a potom sa začneš modliť v tých jazykoch.
And you start to. And you start to. And you then start also to pray in tongues. They said it to me.
A oni mi povedali, proste ty začneš hovoriť v jazykoch.
You know what?
Viete čo?
I'm so happy that I never heard any preaching before why we can't get the Holy Spirit.
A viete, ja som dnes taký šťastný, že predtým som nikdy nepočul také vyučovanie, že prečo by sme nemali mať Ducha Svätého.
Or that we need to be careful not to get the wrong spirit.
Alebo že by sme mali byť opatrní, aby sme nedostali nejakého zlého ducha.
Or the 5 steps to get the Holy Spirit.
Alebo 5 krokov, ako získať Ducha Svätého.
I trusted these guys.
Ja som im dôveroval.
They looked nice.
Vyzerali pekne.
They had something what I don't had.
Mali niečo, čo som ja nemal.
And I needed.
A ja som to potreboval.
Okay, let's do.
Dobre, ideme na to.
I asked the Father in the name of Jesus for the Holy Spirit.
Poprosil som Otca v mene Ježiš o Ducha Svätého.
They laid their hands on me.
Oni na mňa vzložili ruky.
And then they started in this strange language to pray.
A potom sa začali modliť v tom zvláštnom jazyku.
Honda, Honda, Kawasaki, Suzuki. No. Please translate. And I thought, oh no.
Ja som si povedal, o nie.
This sounds like some of these witches in these horror movies what I looked before I was a Christian.
To znie ako mená tých strašidelných tých čarodejníc, keď som kúkal tie hrozné filmy, tie horory.
And I thought, oh Stefan, you always end up in trouble.
A ja som si povedal, Stefan, ty sa vždy dostaneš do nejakého problému.
But somehow this was my mind.
Toto bola moja myseľ.
Somehow I felt something good in it.
Ale nejak som vnímal, že je v tom niečo dobré.
So I started to repeat what I hear the guy saying next to me.
Tak som začal opakovať to, čo som počul.
Not like children, when children grow up, they hear you talking and then they start to repeat.
Tak ako detičky, keď sa učia hovoriť, proste opakujú to, čo počujú.
And I didn't have a teaching.
A nemal som žiadne vyučovanie.
Oh brother, you must feel the power of God and then it comes.
O braček, najprv musíš cítiť Božiu moc a potom to príde.
Oh brother, if you break your tongue, it will come.
Oh brače, keď si zlomíš jazyk, vtedy to príde.
Yeah, some got it. Was actually a joke, yeah.
Samozrejme to bol vtip.
No, but I believed.
Nie, ja som tomu veril.
And I started to speak.
A začal som hovoriť.
And suddenly own words were coming out.
A zrazu začali prichádzať moje vlastné
slova. And in the same moment I felt the same power I felt in the vineyard in this night when I tried to kill myself. I felt the same power coming.
A zároveň som začal vnímať, že tá istá moc ako vtedy vlastne ma zachránila v tú noc. Vnímal som, že je znova tu.
And it was like filling me, was around me.
Bolo to proste všade okolo mňa a naplňalo ma to.
But there was something else.
Ale bolo tam ešte niečo iné.
There was something in me what did not like what is coming there.
Niečo vo mne bolo, čo mu sa nepáčilo, to čo prichádzalo.
And I felt this pressure coming in my head.
A ja som vnímal taký tlak prichádzajúci na moju hlavu.
As the power of the Holy Spirit increased, this pressure went up in my head.
A tak ako moc Ducha Svätého zosilňovala, tak tlak v mojej hlave narastal.
And I could really feel how something left me.
A potom som zrazu vnímal, ako ma niečo opustilo.
And my sister is 20 years older.
A moja sestra, ktorá bola o 20 rokov staršia.
She was in the room.
Bola v tej miestnosti.
And she was not a believer at this time.
A v tom čase nebola veriaca.
She saw a dark cloud coming out of my head.
A ona videla nejaký tmavý oblak, ako vyšiel z mojej hlavy.
Moving through the window.
A proste odišiel von oknom.
You don't need to open the window for the bad spirits.
Zlým duchom nemusíte otvárať okná.
Don't be nice to the evil spirits, okay?
Nebuďte na nich milí.
They are not your friends.
Oni nie sú vašimi priateľmi.
The only thing you say to them is get out here.
Jediná vec, ktorú im poviete, je choďte von.
you also don't need to talk with them long.
Nemusíte s nimi dlho rozprávať.
Like some people do.
Ako niektorí ľudia.
And you know what? I'm so happy that I found then all these things in the Bible.
A viete, čo som veľmi rád, že všetky tieto veci som potom našiel v Biblii.
So I experienced Jesus, he's my savior.
Takže ja som zažil Ježiša, on je môj spasiteľ.
So I told the people Jesus saves.
Takže ja som hovoril ľuďom, Ježiš zachraňuje.
I experienced Jesus as the deliverer.
Ja som prežil Ježiša a zažil som ho ako vysloboditeľa.
So I told them Jesus delivered.
Takže som im hovoril, Ježiš vyslobodzuje.
And I experienced Jesus as the healer.
A takisto som ho zažil ako uzdraviteľa.
So I told them Jesus heals.
Takže som im začal hovoriť, on and uzdravuje.
And you know what? Miracles happened.
A viete čo? Začali sa diať zázraky.
Later then the church taught me all the reasons why he is not healing, why he is not delivering.
A neskôr potom ma cirkev začala učiť, prečo on neuzdravuje, prečo nevyslobodzuje.
And the miracles got less.
A zázraku bolo menej.
You know, does God want to heal everyone or only few people?
Chce snáď Boh uzdraviť každého alebo iba niektorých?
Oh brother, that's my cross what I have to carry this sickness.
Vieš, braček, to je môj kríž, aby som niesol, žil s touto nemocou.
You know that Jesus said it shall happen according to your faith?
A viete, že Ježiš povedal, stane sa vám podľa vašej viery?
So if you believe this, you will get it.
Tak ak tomu tak veríte, budete to tak mať.
If you believe it that you are nothing and the devil can do with you what he wants to do, you get it.
Ak budete veriť, že ste ničím a diabol si môže s vami robiť čo chce, bude to tak.
If you believe, you know, that when this man you can't give your tithe because you have so many debts that the devil comes and destroys you completely, it shall happen according to your faith.
Ak veríte tomu, že musíte proste dávať desiatok, pretože ak ho nedáte, tak príde diabol a proste vás zničí, bude to tak?
But even experiencing all these things,
ale zároveň, ako som zakúšal tieto veci,
there was something missing.
Niečo mi chýbalo.
When I said, our Father in heaven,
keď som povedal, Otče náš, ktorý si v nebesiach,
the word Father was so empty.
To slovo Otec bolo také prázdne.
You know, my mind said, he's a good father, the Bible says he's a good father.
Moja mysel mi hovorila, on je dobrý otec, lebo je to tak v Biblii.
But my heart says, but father means pain.
Ale moje srdce mi hovorilo, otec, to znamená bolesť.
But father means being rejected.
Otec, to znamená odmietnutie.
But father means not being wanted.
Ale otec znamená byť nechcený.
But father means when you come to him,
ale otec znamená, že keď prídeš k nemu,
he says, I have no time, speak with mom.
Tak on povie, nemám na teba čas, choď za maminkou.
You know, in John 14,
a v Jánovi 14,
verse 18,
verš 18,
Jesus says something really interesting.
Ježiš povedal niečo veľmi zaujímavé.
He speaks about going to the Father.
Hovorí o tom, že ide k Otcovi.
And then he says, I will not leave you without comforter or orphan.
A on hovorí,
I will not leave you as orphans.
Ja vás nezanechám ako siroty.
And you know, at this time, because Jesus also called his disciples children.
A v tomto čase Ježiš ich nazval svojich učeníkov aj deťmi.
I think one is in John 13, verse 33, where he says, my little children.
V Jánovi 30, 13 hovorí moje dietky.
Because in this time a spiritual master or rabuni, a rabbi,
pretože v tom čase duchovný vodca alebo rabbi
was a father figure. Was a father figure.
Bol vlastne taká postava otcovská.
And the followers were like children.
A jeho nasledovníci boli ako jeho deti.
And when the master, the rabuni died,
a keď ten majster, ten rabbi, rabuni zomrel,
they were like orphans.
Tak ostali ako siroty.
And Jesus says here something really interesting.
A Ježiš tu hovorí niečo naozaj zaujímavé.
He says, guys, when I go,
hovorí, priatelia, keď ja odídem,
it will not end for you.
Pre vás to nekončí.
There will someone come,
niekto príde,
who gives you all what the Father gives you.
Vám dá vám všetko, čo vám dáva Otec.
You know, many people think Jesus came to carry the sin of the world.
Viete, mnohí ľudia si myslia, veria, že Ježiš prišiel, aby vzal hriech celého sveta.
But came for so much more.
Ale on prišiel pre niečo oveľa viac.
And people, as I talk,
a ľudia, ako ja hovorím,
the Holy Spirit is already healing people.
Ako v tom čase, keď ja hovorím, tak Duch Svätý už uzdravuje ľudí.
There is someone here you had already today, and I think yesterday it started, very strong pain in your lower part here around the
Niekto z vás today, niekto z vás, niekomu z vás už dnes alebo predtým začala veľmi silná bolesť v tej oblasti.
It's almost like cramps.
Je to akoby slepé črevo?
And it's not the first time you have this?
Nestalo sa vám to prvýkrát?
And you were even concerned about what could it be?
A dosť ste tým proste máte strach, čo to môže byť.
I think this is what your father wants to tell you, your father in heaven.
Myslím si, že toto ti chce Otec nebeský povedať.
Daughter, your time of inner battle is finished.
Tento čas tvojej vnútorného boja je u konca.
I will bring to you the peace I've promised you.
Ja ti dávam ten pokoj, ktorý som ti zaslúbil.
And I'm not against you.
A nie som proti tebe.
The devil tried to tell you that I've forgotten you.
Diabol sa ti snažil povedať, že som na teba zabudol.
But the Lord is saying, how could I?
Ale pán ti hovorí, ako by som mohol.
Even in the early years, I heard your prayers.
Ešte v tvojich mladých rokoch ja som počul tvoje modlitby.
And you are worshipper.
A ty si uctievačka.
And this is why the enemy attacks you.
A to na toto diabol útočí.
He has driven you in a corner.
On ťa zahnal do kúta.
He tries to intimidate you.
Snaží sa ťa proste zmenšiť, aby si sa cítila malá, zastrašiť.
Remember who your father is.
Ale pamätaj, kto je tvoj otec.
Step out in faith.
Vykroč vo viere.
Don't be afraid. I don't want to do something wrong to God.
Neboj sa, aby si sa že sa pomýliš, že urobíš chybu.
You're a very creative person.
Si veľmi tvorivá osoba.
But your creativity was always held back because the way you see yourself.
Ale tvoja tvorivosť bola vždycky potlačená tým, ako si samu seba videla.
And the father saying, daughter.
A otec ti hovorí, dcérka.
Release the creativity.
Uvoľni tú tvorivosť.
You are my wonderful daughter.
Si moja nádherná dcéra.
And my eyes upon you in this time.
A ja mám svoje oči na tebe.
You can't see the way now. You can't see the way now.
Teraz to ešte nevidíš, tú cestu.
But I will guide you step by step, the
Ale ja
ťa God is saying.
Krok po kroku povediem, hovorí Pánov
duch. And the pain has also somehow something to do with your back.
Tá bolesť má niečo aj s tvojim chrbtom.
And the Lord is touching this now.
A Pán sa toho teraz dotýka.
And I would not be surprised if you feel now or very soon some warmth going in your body.
A je možné, že v tomto čase alebo proste budeš cítiť teplo.
From today on,
od dnes,
you will see that the word is true.
Budeš vidieť, že to slovo je pravdivé.
The fruit of your hand is blessed.
A to ovocie tvojich rúk je požehnané.
And you have in you also the ability.
A takisto máš v sebe schopnosť
to start your own things.
Začať svoje vlastné veci.
To be self-employed.
Byť proste samostatná.
And to lead people.
A viesť ľudí.
As you let him show you how he sees you.
Ak mu dovolíš, aby ti ukázal, ako ťa on vidí.
You will be released in this strong, powerful woman you are.
Budeš uvoľnená do tej moci tej ženy, ktorá skutočne si.
And the Lord has given you a very merciful heart.
A Pán ti dal veľmi milosrdné srdce.
And compassionate heart who feels for the others.
A srdce, ktoré súcití s ostatnými.
And sometimes because of this it's like this burden is upon you.
A preto niekedy máš na sebe také bremeno.
And the Lord is saying, I will teach you how to handle it.
A Pán ti hovorí, ja ťa naučím, ako s tým zaobchádzať.
But you will always show my mercy to the people around you.
Ale ty budeš vždy ukazovať, preukazovať moju milosť, moje milosrdenstvo ľuďom okolo teba. A takisto máš v sebe piesne, ktoré potrebujú byť uvoľnené. Slová, ktoré majú byť napísané. Takže netráp sa tým, čo si niekto druhý myslí. A vykroč krok po kroku a uvidíš tie veci. Vďaka ti, Oče.
Someone who has from here to here pain.
Niekto z vás má bolesť tu na ruke.
I think even if I see it right in the spirit, you banged your elbow somewhere, but there's still pain there.
A ja v duchu vnímam, že ste si akoby udreli váš lakeť a máte tam bolesť.
Who is this?
Je to niekto? Kto to je?
Did you? What is it, which one is it? When did you bang it?
Kedy ste si to udreli?
And is there still pain?
Štyri.
Okay, I pray for you, but there's also a woman here.
Budem sa modliť, ale je tu ešte aj žena.
There's also a woman here.
Je tu aj žena.
Okay, is it you too? Okay, lay your hands there.
Dajte si tam, položte si tam ruku.
Is it this way? Where is it?
Kde to je? Kde?
Yeah, okay. But also, even if I don't call your sickness.
Ak náhodou nenazvem vašu bolesť alebo vašu nemoc,
don't sit there and say, oh, I'm waiting till he has mine.
Tak nesete len tak, že budem čakať, až povie mňa.
When you see God is doing something,
keď vidíte, že Boh niečo robí,
you say, I'm also your child.
Tak môžete povedať, a ja som tvoje dieťa.
Have you seen children?
Videli ste deti?
Put two children here, put five here.
Dajte tu 5 detí.
And give one a sweet.
A dajte tu jeden cukríček.
And tell me what will happen.
Spovedzte, čo sa stane.
You know, the same you.
To je to isté, je to s nami.
Be like the children.
My sme ako deti.
Because you know what?
Lebo viete čo?
God loves you in the same way.
Boh vás miluje takisto.
Like he loves your neighbor. Like he loves your neighbor. He loves you.
Takisto ako miluje vášho blízkeho, blížneho.
You all can feel like the favorite child.
Vy sa všetci môžete cítiť ako obľúbené dieťa.
So long as you not forget.
Takže kým nezabudnete.
The person next to you is also favorite child.
Aj ten, kto sedí vedľa vás, je to milované dieťa.
Say ahoj, favorite child.
Takže môžete sa pozdraviť, ahoj, obľúbené dieťa. Môžete povedať svojmu susedovi.
Okay, put there.
Takže dajte si tam ruku.
And I pray now for all the things what have to do with bones, what have to do with stuff.
Ja sa budem teraz modliť za všetky veci, ktoré majú čo dočinenia s kĺbmi a rukami.
Please don't expect it from me.
Prosím, neočakávajte to odo mňa.
It's his love to you.
Je to jeho láska k vám.
You can't earn it.
Nemôžete si to nijak zaslúžiť.
Get it by praying more or reading more the Bible.
Ani tým, že budete sa viac modliť alebo viac čítať Bibliu.
Jesus said it's finished.
Ježiš povedal, je to hotové.
So in the name of Jesus I release healing in this place.
Takže v mene Ježiš ja vyslobodzujem Božiu moc na tomto mieste.
Father, please touch your children, whatever is the problem, Lord.
Dotkni sa svojich detí, akýkoľvek je problém.
In Jesus name.
Mene Ježiš.
Thank you, Father.
Ďaká, Otče.
Thank you, Lord.
Ďaká, Pane.
Thank you, Lord.
Ďaká, Pane.
Thank you, Father.
Ďaká,
listen,
Otecko.
What's your name?
Ako sa voláte?
Anton. Anton, you might not see yourself like this.
Možno sa tak nevidíte.
But a father is saying you are a man of faith.
Ale otec hovorí, si mužom viery.
And that's the reason why the devil constantly attacks your faith.
A to je dôvodom, prečo diabol neustále napáda tvoju vieru.
Because he doesn't want you to become this man of faith.
Pretože on nechce, aby si sa stal týmto človekom viery.
But in the same way, you know, Thomas wanted a sign.
Ale takisto Tomáš si žiadal znamenie.
And Jesus said, blessed are the ones who don't need one.
A Ježiš povedal, blahoslavení sú tí, ktorí nepotrebujú znamenie.
And the father saying, son,
a otec hovorí, synu,
I will not give you a sign.
Ja ti nedám znamenie.
You have to trust me.
Musíš mi dôverovať.
You have to learn to stand on my word.
Musíš sa naučiť stáť na mojom
and
slove.
You will see that I prepare a way for you.
A uvidíš, že ja som pripravil cestu pre teba.
Don't compare God with Christians.
Neporovnávaj Boha s kresťanmi.
Don't compare his personality what Christian has done to you.
Neporovnávaj jeho osobnosť s týmto, čo ti kresťania kedy urobili.
He's a kind God, a good God.
On je dobrý Boh.
But he wants us to grow.
Ale chce, aby sme rástli.
So sometimes he allows things in our life to discipline us in a good way.
Takže on niekedy dovoluje veci v našom živote, aby nás dobrým spôsobom proste vychovával.
So he's for you, not against you.
Takže on je pre teba, za teba, nie proti
tebe.
Stand
up against the spirit of condemnation.
Takže postav sa proti tomu duchu odmietnutia.
Because there is no condemnation for you in Christ.
Pretože v Kristu pre teba nie je žiadne odmietnutie.
And learn and focus of who you are in Christ.
A nauč sa, kto si, zameraj sa na to, kto si v Kristu.
And then you will see that the walk will be easier.
A potom uvidíš, že ten život je jednoduchší. Tá cesta.
Giving you your own faith now.
Lebo on ti dáva svoju vlastnú vieru teraz.
Because you lived from the faith of others and this is why he had to strip away certain things.
Pretože doteraz si žil z viery iných ľudí a preto musel nejaké veci popustiť. To je objatie od tvojho otecka z neba.
Yeah, don't say sir to me. I feel so old when you say sir.
Nehovorte mi pane, lebo sa cítim taký starý.
Because I have the heart of an 18-year-old.
Lebo ja mám srdce 18-ročného mladíka.
Cheers for Jesus. You know, When I came here,
viete, keď som sem prišiel,
the Bible says prophecy is in parts.
In 1 Corinthians, 1. Korinským, že proroctvo,
in 1 Corinthians 13, it says it's in parts. We receive in parts.
Aha, že je čiastočné, jasné.
So even when someone stands here in the front and he starts,
sorry.
Even if someone stands here and he starts to prophesy,
takže ak niekto stojí vpredu a začne prorokovať,
and it looks like, wow, God is standing behind him and must speak in his ear because he is so sure.
A my si myslíme, wow, Boh stojí za ním a hovorí k nemu a on proste hovorí tak isto.
We have learned to walk on the water.
Ale my sme sa naučili chodiť po vode.
But we also do still mistakes.
Ale stále robíme chyby.
And that's good.
A to je dobré.
Because if we would not do mistakes, we would not need God.
Pretože ak by sme nerobili chyby, tak by sme nepotrebovali Boha.
And Paul would not say test everything.
A Pavol by nepovedal všetko skúšajte.
So what is he saying? We shall test and do what?
Takže čo povedal? Máme skúšať a čo?
To keep the dobre? Okay.
A podržať to, čo je dobré.
But you know how we test sometimes.
A viete, ako nás testuje niekedy?
Oh, I like this prophecy.
A toto proroctvo sa mi páči.
Changing? No, I don't want this prophecy. Changing? I don't want this prophecy to change. I don't want this to change. No. Yeah.
Nechcem, aby sa to zmenilo.
So we pick out what we want.
Aha, čiže proste niečo počujem, ale to sa mi nezdá. Chcem, aby sa to zmenilo. Tak si vyberiem to, čo sa mi páči.
Wife, submit to your husband. Oh, yeah.
Prečo by som sa mala podriadiť manželovi?
Husband, love your wife like Christ.
Muži, milujte svoje ženy ako Kristus.
I'm too busy, God. I can't hear you.
Bože, ja ťa nepočujem. Čiže si vyberáme to, čo chceme počuť.
But what the Bible means is,
ale to, čo Biblia tým myslí,
the word testing,
to tým slovom testujte,
means
skúšajte,
to look how much of God is in it.
Znamená, pozrite sa na to, do akej miery je v tom Boh.
Like someone who looks at gold, how much purity is in it.
Ako napríklad niekto pozerá na zlato, ako do akej miery je proste čisté, nakoľko je čisté.
So sometimes I get like jigsaws, like parts of a puzzle.
Niekedy dostanem ako pucle, čiastočky, skladačky.
And I don't understand it.
A nerozumiem tomu.
It sometimes it could be four parts.
Niekedy mám 4 čiastočky.
And it doesn't mean anything for me.
A vôbec to nič neznamená.
But for the person.
Ale pre toho človeka.
And it could be that three parts 100% right?
A možno tie 3 čiastočky.
And one part not totally 100%.
Budú 100%, ale tá jedna nebude 100%.
Please don't sit there and say no, it was only 99%, so it's not me.
Tak prosím vás, nesete s tým, že to bolo iba 99%, takže to nie je pre mňa.
Because we receive
to nebolo z Boha.
We receive the word.
Pretože my dostávame slovo.
But the mistakes happen sometimes in the interpretation and the application.
Niekedy sa stane proste tá chyba aj v tom tlmočení alebo v tej aplikácii.
And this is where usually with prophetic people, especially when they're young in ministry and learn, where the most mistakes happen.
A najviac chýb sa robí v prorockej službe, proste keď mladý človek sa treba učí.
But brother, they say, this is the Lord.
Ale proste toto hovorí Pán, prorok povedal.
Yeah, and I should not do this in the beginning.
Toto by sme nemali robiť na začiatku.
I should rather say, I think God wants to tell you.
Mali by sme radšej povedať, no myslím si, že Pán ti hovorí toto.
Or like in the New Testament, you know, I think the Holy Spirit wants to tell you.
Alebo proste ako v Novom zákone, myslím, že Duch Svätý ti chce povedať.
Does anyone has a pastor who preaches every Sunday from the beginning of the sermon to the end? The 100% pure word of the Lord.
Poznáte takého pastora, ktorý by v nedeľu kázal od začiatku kázne až po konca 100% čisté Božie slovo?
Don't put your hand up.
Nedávajte ruku hore.
You know, we don't want your pastor to know some things.
Nechceme, aby váš pastor niečo
vedel.
No one
preaches all the time 100% pure God.
Nikto nekáže čisté Božie slovo. 100%.
Because we are sometimes influenced from the church background where we're coming from.
Pretože niekedy sme proste ovplyvnení tým pozadím, z akého pochádzame.
The churches that will never preach about the gifts of the Spirit or the Holy Spirit.
A nie všetky cirkvi vyučujú o daroch Ducha Svätého.
But it's in the Bible, it's very clear.
Ale v Biblii je to veľmi jasné.
That's why we all need to go back to the word of God and see if it is really like this.
Takže potrebujeme ísť späť do Božieho slova a zistiť, či je to naozaj tak.
So,
Takže,
when I came here,
keď som sem prišiel,
I heard the Spirit of God, or I think I heard the Spirit of God saying,
tak som vnímal, alebo myslím si, že som vnímal, že Duch Svätý hovorí,
first of all, speaking to me about a doll.
Sorry?
A doll. A doll. You know what girls have, little girls,
aha,
a doll.
Zdá sa mi, že hovoril o nejakej bábike.
And I saw this doll broken.
A videl som tú bábiku zlomenú.
And I heard the name Anuška.
A počul som meno Anuška.
And then it suddenly changed in Nuška.
Potom sa to zrazu zmenilo na Nuška.
And as I was asking the Lord, I had a sense.
A ja som vnímal,
that someone either knows Anuška or is here is called like this, and you had a doll which you loved very much, and whatever reason it was destroyed, and it was quite traumatic for you.
A ja som, ja proste vnímam, že buď niekto z vás tu je taký, ktorý ste mali takúto bábiku a buď bola nejakým spôsobom zničená.
And in all of this something with porcelain had to do. I don't know if the doll was from porcelain.
Nejakým spôsobom
porcelain played a role in
to malo, to malo niečo s porcelánom. Neviem, či tá bábika bola z porcelánu.
Yeah. And I also believe that the number 8 means something to you.
A takisto si myslím, že číslo 8 niečo pre vás znamená.
And it could speak about a time period of 8 years or you were 8 years.
A hovorí to o časovej perióde 8 rokov alebo ste mali vtedy 8 rokov.
And you see, I'm going out in the water now.
Takže vidíte, že ja vlastne vykračujem teraz na tú vodu.
And I risk to look stupid.
A riskujem, že budem vyzerať proste
hlúpo. I'd rather look stupid and then miss something where you're not blessed.
Ale ja radšej proste budem vyzerať hlúpo, ale
ja?
When I was 8,
okay, so when you were 8 years, you had a dream, and you went down the stairs, and there was a porcelain doll who was broken. Yeah.
From that time on, she started to have dreams.
And from this time on, you had dreams.
Bad dreams.
Bad dreams. I have good news for you.
Mám pre vás dobrú správu.
You will not more have bad dreams.
Už nebudete mať zlé sny.
You are released in the name of Jesus.
Ste z toho uvoľnená v mene Ježiš.
And the evil spirits who have tormented you.
A tí zlí duchovia, ktorí vás trápili,
and especially in the area of fear,
a zvlášť v oblasti strachu,
I declare you free.
Ste
and I tell you
slobodná.
Why, and
poviem
I tell
vám prečo.
Why they have tried to destroy your life.
Poviem ti, prečo sa snažili zničiť váš život v duchu.
Because you have a strong prophetic anointing.
Pretože máte silné prorocké pomazanie.
And you will dream dreams, but good dreams.
Ale vy budete, a vy budete mať sny, ale dobré sny.
You will dream dreams from God.
Budete snívať sny od Boha.
And the fear who have isolated you and kept you will go.
A ten strach, ktorý vás izoloval, odíde.
And I tell you something else.
A ešte niečo vám poviem.
The devil tried to tell you this is a punishment of God.
Diabol sa vám snažil proste povedať, že toto je trest od Boha.
And he has even used people who call themselves Christians.
A používal pritom ľudí, ktorí sa nazývajú kresťanmi.
It's not a curse.
To nie je kliatba.
It's not a punishment.
To nie je žiadny trest.
These devils saw the angels around you.
Ale tí démoni videli tých anielov okolo vás.
And there's something else.
A ešte je niečo.
I have a sense like the Lord also protected you of some water or some drowning or something.
Ja takisto vnímam, že Pán vás ťa vyslobodil akoby z niečo s vodou alebo utopenie alebo niečo
také.
Or
did you have dreams about this?
Alebo ste mali také sny?
My brother
wanted her to. So yeah, so your brother wanted to join you. Yeah. You know what? You are alive because God protected you.
Teraz si živá, pretože Pán ťa ochránil.
Come here. We all pray together now for this lady.
Budeme sa spolu modliť za túto
pani. And the United Church of God.
Ako spojená cirkev,
and I don't care how you call you, Baptist, wild, charismatic angel or whatever.
Tom, či ste baptista alebo charizmatický.
That's your sister.
To je vaša sestrička.
And we stretch out our hands as a sign that we bless her.
Takže vystrieme svoju ruku ako znamenie, že ju žehnáme.
And Father, we thank you so much.
Otecko, ďakujeme ti tak veľmi.
As your servant. I declare today.
Ja dnes vyhlasujem.
finished.
Je to hotové.
All this torment is finished.
Toto utrpenie je u konca.
I release you in
Jesus' name. Ja ťa uvoľňujem v mene Ježiš.
And I hear the Spirit of God saying.
Ja vnímam Duch Svätý hovorí.
Daughter.
Dcéra.
I spoke to your heart.
Ja som hovoril k tvojmu srdcu.
You shall live.
Ty budeš žiť.
And that's why you live.
A to je preto, prečo žiješ.
And that's why you will have overflowing life.
A budeš mať život, ktorý prekypuje.
This is the hand of your Father in heaven.
Toto je ruka tvojho Otca v nebi.
He says, "You are my beloved daughter."
A on ti hovorí, si moja milovaná dcérka.
These devils will leave your house.
A títo démoni opustia tvoj dom.
And they will not torment you.
A už ťa viac nebudú sužovať.
And I will open your spiritual eyes, the Lord
is saying. A ja otvorím tvoj duchovný zrak, hovorí Pán.
That you will see that there are more on your side.
Aby si videla, že viac je na tvojej strane.
Because the devils are afraid of you.
Pretože démoni sa ťa boja.
And the Father saying, daughter.
A otec ti hovorí, dcéra.
I remember the times when you were singing songs to me.
Ja si pamätám ten čas, keď si mi spievala piesne.
And I want to hear these songs again.
A ja ich chcem počuť znovu.
I release you in grace.
Ja ťa uvoľňujem do milosti.
In the peace of your Father.
Do pokoja tvojho otca.
No more pain, no more nightmares.
Žiadna bolesť a žiadne nočné mory viac.
Joy and overflowing life.
Ukáž jej ten prekypujúci život.
Thank you, Father.
Ďaká ti, Oče.
There is your love. Thank you, Lord.
Ďaká ti, Pane.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. It's going, yeah. It's all going. Thank you, Lord. And the hand towards your neck.
Polož si ruku na svoj krk.
And the hand who have been in her neck. I'm speaking symbolically. The hand who have been in her neck.
A tá ruka, ktorá bola na tom krku, položená.
I break the power of this hand.
Ničím tú moc tej ruky.
Jesus name.
Mene Ježiš. Lámem tú moc.
Listen, sweetheart. Do you understand English?
Yeah, I can understand.
You're very special. Don't believe anything else. You don't deserve this. And you know what? The things have started to flee. And when they come, you tell them, in the name of Jesus, you will not more come. Because they will try once more, but you're strong enough. Jesus is with you. His angels are around you. You will have dreams from God, and you will have the peace in your life you were looking for. Don't worry. And don't worry about any sickness or any reactions on your body, because the Lord has touched you today. Okay? There's life for you there. Yeah?
Thank you.
You're welcome. God is so good.
Boh je tak dobrý.
You know, I was in a church as a minister.
Bol som v cirkvi ako služobník.
I'm totally away now from my preaching. I'm totally away now. I have even teraz started úplne, my preaching.
Úplne mimo od toho, čo som chcel kázať.
I was in a church and they asked me to do the announcements.
Bol som v cirkvi a poprosili ma, aby som dal nejaké oznamy.
Never ask a prophetic person to do announcements.
Nikdy neproste prorockú osobu, aby urobila oznamy.
So I went up with my list.
Takže som dostal ten zoznam.
And I wanted to do the announcements.
A chcel som urobiť oznam.
And I stood there.
Tak som sa tam postavil.
I looked at the announcements.
Pozrel som na oznamy.
I looked to God.
Pozrel som na Boha.
And said, Andrea.
Hovorím, Andrea.
Don't get divorced.
Nerozvádzaj sa.
People shocked.
Ľudia v šoku.
Pointed on the lady.
Ukázal som na pani.
Said you are from the new age.
Vy ste z new age.
And you came today here to see if God is real.
A dnes ste prišli sem, aby ste zistili, či Boh je skutočný.
He says yes, he's real.
A on hovorí, áno, som skutočný.
And she was. And you know, and I said there is a couple.
A hovorím, je tu dvojica.
You know, there were 2000 people in the place. There's a couple.
2000 ľudí tam bolo. On hovorí, je tu do nejaká dvojica.
And it looks like you lose your house.
A zdá sa, že ste stratili domov.
You both are sick.
Ste obaja chorí.
And your mother-in-law is very sick.
A vaša svokra je veľmi chorá.
Come afterwards to the front, we pray for you.
Takže poďte dopredu, budeme sa modliť.
And people were shocked.
A ľudia boli v šoku.
Because they were expecting the announcements.
Lebo oni čakali tie oznamy.
But God wanted to do a different announcement.
Alebo chcel urobiť iné oznamy.
He was not interested in the moment on the coffee meeting of the old people on Wednesday.
Jeho vôbec nezaujímalo práve to stretnutie pri káve.
Or to announce a new service.
alebo oznámenie ďalšej bohoslužby.
He wanted to announce freedom for people.
On chcel ohlásiť slobodu ľuďom.
And on Tuesday we had staff meeting.
A v utorok sme mali stretnutie vedúcich.
And one of our staff was sitting in the back in the church.
A jeden z tých vedúcich sedel vzadu v cirkvi.
And he said, when I said from the front, Andrea, don't get divorced.
A on počul, keď som adresoval tej Andrei, aby sa nerozvádzala.
A woman broke in tears. She was starting to cry.
A tá žena proste sa úplne zlomila a začala plakať.
So we went to her and said, what's the problem?
A on prišiel a pýta sa, čo je, aký je problém.
She said, my name is Andrea.
A ona hovorí, volám sa Andrea.
And my husband cheated on me. He had other relationship.
A môj manžel ma podvádza.
But he repented.
Ale on urobil pokánie.
And I didn't know if it's real.
Ale ja neviem, či je to skutočné.
So I asked God, shall I get divorced?
Tak som sa spýtala Boha, mám sa rozviesť?
Or is his repentance real?
Alebo je jeho pokánie skutočné?
And God's announcement on this morning was.
A takže to Božie oznámenie v to ráno.
Andrea, don't get divorced.
Bolo, Andrea, nerozvádzaj sa.
One sentence.
Jedna veta.
Has saved the marriage.
Zachránila to manželstvo.
And there are people who say we don't need a prophetic.
A sú ľudia, ktorí stále hovoria, nepotrebujeme proroctvo.
You know, I could tell you story over story.
Mohol by som vám hovoriť príbeh za príbehom.
But the thing is, as we grow, we prophetic people.
Ale vec je tá, že a keď rastieme ako prorockí ľudia,
we do mistakes.
Robíme chyby.
And we need to have grace with the prophetic people.
A potrebujeme proste milosť.
So long as they are teachable. So long as they're teachable.
Takže kým proste sme vyučovateľní.
The problem is.
Problém je.
That people who don't know about the prophetic try to teach prophetic people.
Je, že ľudia, ktorí nevedia o proroctve, sa snažia vyučovať prorockých ľudí.
This is why in the first church there were prophets.
Preto v prvej cirkvi tam boli skutoční proroci.
And people were there to learn. People were there to learn.
A ľudia sa tam mohli učiť.
So I want to encourage you.
Takže vás chcem povzbudiť.
Look in the word.
Pozrite sa do slova.
Ask the Holy Spirit.
Proste Ducha Svätého.
You know, and if you have a word for people,
a ak máte slovo pre ľudí,
you don't need to change.
Nemusíte sa zmeniť.
This says the Lord.
Toto hovorí Pán.
You know, or you don't need to speak in your, what is your, we have King James translation, what is the Czech translation of well known one?
Že ako máme nejakú takú preklad Biblie, nejaký iný preklad. Kralická Bible.
That's a long sentence for a translation. Yeah, you don't need to sound like your Bible translation.
Takže nemusíte znieť ako ten preklad vašej Biblie.
No, God the Father loves to talk to us.
Proste Boh Otec miluje k vám hovoriť.
When you are down and you condemn yourself.
Keď ste na tom zlé a sa odsudzujete samých seba.
I mean, remember Jesus, what did he say?
Spomeňte si na to, čo povedal Ježiš.
He was constantly battling against this wrong picture which people had about God.
On neustále bojoval proti tomu zlému obrazu, aký ľudia mali o Bohu.
He said, you are parents.
Hovorí, vy ste rodičmi.
And you give good things to your people.
A dávate dobré dary svojim deťom.
So how much more your father in heaven?
Takže o čo skôr váš Otec v nebi?
You know what the problem is?
Viete, čo je problém?
That there are many leaders out there who don't know the father.
Že je veľmi veľa vedúcich, ktorí nepoznajú Otca.
They can preach about him?
Môžu o ňom kázať?
Like me.
Ako ja.
I was many years in ministry.
Ja som bol mnoho rokov v službe.
I could preach about the father heart of God.
Mohol som kázať o Božom otcovskom srdci.
I could speak about the father of God.
Mohol som o tom rozprávať.
I sounded very loud when I prophesied.
A hovoril som veľmi nahlas, keď som prorokoval.
Because loud is powerful.
Pretože teraz to je mocné.
And if I'm loud, I must be a mighty prophet.
A keď som tu, tak to je proste mocný prorok.
But you know,
hlasný. Áno, keď som hlasný.
Prophecy is more than words.
Ale proroctvo je viac ako slova.
Is words carried by the heart of the Father.
Sú to slova, ktoré sú prinášané otcovským srdcom.
It's the Father coming down in your darkness.
Je to Otec, ktorý prichádza dole do vašej temnoty.
Saying, get up.
A hovorí, poď vstaň.
Remember who you are.
Spomeň si, kým si.
Remember who your Father is.
Spomeň si, kto je tvoj Otec.
Not called to be down there in the hole.
Ty nie si povolaný, aby si bol tam dole.
I'm with you.
Ja som s tebou.
Even if you can't stand up in the moment.
Hoci aj nie si schopný vstať v tom momente.
He says, I'm with you until you're ready.
Ale on hovorí, ja som aj tak s tebou, pokiaľ nebudeš pripravený.
And I would speak words of life to you.
A bude ti hovoriť slova života.
Until you can stand up in this life.
Až pokým nebudeš schopný znova vstať do toho života.
Yeah, I think the Lord wants shows me something about a certain car.
Myslím, že pán mi ukázal niečo certain what?
I saw a Beetle. You know the car? VW.
Aha, v nejakom probably aute. Beetle. Videl som akoby chrobáka, auto, chrobáka, BMW, Volkswagen Brogue.
Yeah, and he had a light blue color.
Malo to svetlomodrú farbu.
And somehow this is strange. It's almost like, you know, there was a movie about the Beetle, what was it called, Herbie or whatever? You know,
bol taký nejaký film o takomto chrobákovi?
Yeah, and it's almost like you wanted this car to be like Herbie. Or the word, no, just a moment. I think I need to follow up again here. I think the word Herbie means something to you.
Ja si myslím, že asi to slovo Herbie. Herbie, niečo pre niekoho z vás toto slovo niečo znamená. Herbie. Yeah.
Or something, yeah, no, yeah, no.
To auto sa tak volalo.
Like this, something like this, Herbie, or something like this.
Alebo niečo podobné.
Did you say you know someone with this name? Did you say you know someone with this name?
Hovorili ste, že poznáte niekoho s takým menom? It was in that film.
Okay, yeah. No, that's not what I mean. So there is
toto nemyslím.
There is this light blue beetle.
Takže je tento bledomodrý chrobák.
Like, he's not more alive. He's standing there around. You know, it's,
on tam proste len tak stojí.
So was something in your past no, he's only stretching. Don't stretch in a meeting where prophet is, you know.
Keď sa prorokuje, tak sa nenaťahujte. Prosím.
Don't stretch when the altar call is, you know. Do you want to give Jesus?
Keď je výzva, tak sa nenaťahujte zrovna.
Give me a moment. Let me tune in.
Dajte mi takú
Father,
chvíľočku.
Thank you. Okay, I think it has something to do with your uncle.
Takže myslím si, že to má niečo dočinenia s vaším
And there is this light strýkom. Blue car.
Strýkom. Je tam to bledomodré auto?
And you know, and VW, in VW in German means Volkswagen. The car
po nemecky to znamená Volkswagen. Proste auto pre ľudí.
And I think if I get this interpretation right, I think your uncle was involved somehow in a Volkspolizei.
Je možné, že váš strýko bol nejakým spôsobom mal niečo spoločné s ľudovou políciou?
But there is a Volkspolizei or Volkspartei, something like this.
Je taká nejaká buď akoby ľudová polícia alebo ľudová strana?
And I think there's a distance in the family between him and
a myslím si, že je nejaká akoby rozmedzie, nejaký priestor medzi how do you mean it?
There's a distance between the relationships in the family.
Aha, vo vzťahu, čiže vo vzťahu je nejaké oddelenie akoby medzi vami a ním.
I see him away and I think it's a distance of relationship, but it could be also that he's very far away.
Takže ja ho proste vnímam, že je niekde ďaleko, ale môže to byť aj fyzická vzdialenosť, ale môže to byť aj akoby vzťahová vzdialenosť vo vzťahu k nemu.
In fact, there is a lot of struggles in your family.
A v skutočnosti vo vašej rodine je veľa takých bojov.
And it's not only your uncle, someone else have dealt with old cars.
A netýka sa to iba toho vášho strýka, ale in your family? Ešte niekto v tejto rodine má niečo dočinenia s autami.
Okay, who does this make any sense to anyone?
Niekomu z vás to niečo hovorí?
You know, even if you say 90% of it.
Možno ak iba 90%.
What is it?
Čo to je?
Yeah, but I think it stands for German because in my heart I had that he's from Germany.
Ale ja som to mal v srdci, že je z Nemecka.
Yeah. Are you here with your family? Are you here with your family?
Ste tu so svojou rodinou? No, mám tady časť rodiny,
he's ill and he came to Czech Republic in the past. He passed away.
Yeah.
I was taking care of him when he was here. He was ill, and the family got.
Oh, the family got apart. And this could be also why I saw him away. This could be that means passed away, you know.
Takže to je vlastně ten důvod pravděpodobně, prečo som ho viděl ďaleko, že vlastně on už zomrel.
I'm having a word for you in a moment.
Mám pre vás slovo, pre teba.
Is anyone here who is not a Christian yet who says I'm not a Christian and I'm proud of it?
Je tu niekto z vás, kto ešte nie je kresťanom a píši sa tým, hrdí sa tým, že nie je kresťan?
Oh, could be. I'm only asking case.
Ja sa iba pýtam, je to možné?
Father, thank you so much.
Vďaka ti, Oče, tak veľmi.
That you will going to establish the prophetic here. You are going to establish the prophetic in this area.
Že ty chceš ustanoviť proroctvo, prorockú službu v tejto oblasti.
And we declare in the name of Jesus Christ.
A my vyhlasujeme v mene Ježiša Krista.
That everything what tries to stand now against the prophetic.
Že čokoľvek stojí proti prorockej službe.
Will have no success in the name of Jesus.
Nebude úspešné v mene Ježiš.
We are here in the name of our Father.
My sme tu v mene nášho Otca.
We are here in the name of Jesus Christ.
My sme tu v mene Ježiša Krista.
And we welcome the Holy Spirit here and in this place.
A my vítame Ducha Svätého tu a na tomto
mieste. And in this region.
A on sa vystiera.
And Holy Spirit, forgive us.
A Duchu Svätý, odpusť nám.
Where people have talked against you and your gifts.
Keď ľudia hovorili proti tebe a proti tvojim darom.
And the Spirit of God is saying.
A Duch Svätý hovorí.
I'm going to give you a sign.
Ja vám dám znamenie.
And the sign will be.
A to znamenie bude.
That water will come out of the ground.
Že voda proste vyjde zo zástupu.
And they will even find new wells in the area.
A dokonca budú nájdené nové pramene.
And they will write in the papers about it.
A bude to práve.
They will write in the papers about it.
A bude sa o tom písať v novinách.
That they have found water where they not thought that's water there.
Že našli vodu tam, kde neočakávali vodu.
And the Spirit of God is saying.
A Duch Pánov hovorí.
I'm changing this atmosphere here.
Ja mením tú atmosféru tu.
And I'm going to crash the spirit of depression.
A ja zničím toho ducha depresie.
And I'm going to crash the suicidal spirit.
A ja zničím toho ducha samovraždy.
And I'm going to crash witchcraft.
A ja zničím čarodejníctvo.
And the Spirit of God is saying.
A Duch Boží hovorí.
And there will be great there will be big gatherings.
Budú veľké zhromaždenia.
Of worship meetings.
Uctievania.
Where altars of praise and worship will be released in this area.
Keď proste oltáre uctievania chvály budú uvoľnené v tejto oblasti.
And you will see in this region.
A v tomto regióne uvidíte,
that a big company will settle in this region,
že v tomto regióne bude sa začne nejaká veľká company,
and we'll bring
spoločnosť,
and we'll bring work to this region.
A prinesie prácu pre tento región.
And the people would say, why this place?
A ľudia povedia, prečo práve tu?
And even the people from the company will not know why this place.
A dokonca ani tí ľudia z tej spoločnosti nebudú rozumieť, prečo
and they would
tu.
Say, something draw us to this place.
A oni povedia, niečo nás sem proste pritiahlo.
And it will be a sign from the Lord.
A to bude znamením od Pána.
That he's building his church.
Že on buduje svoju cirkev.
Because the Spirit of God.
Pretože Duch Pánov.
Has declared over this region.
On už deklaroval nad týmto regiónom.
Let my people go.
Nech moji ľudia idú.
And the Spirit of God says.
A Duch Pánov hovorí.
And you will see that Jesus will build church.
A vy uvidíte, že Ježiš si buduje svoju cirkev.
And the Spirit of God is saying.
A Duch Pánov hovorí.
Leaders in this area.
Vedúcim v tejto oblasti.
Sons and daughters.
Synovia a céry.
I want to work with you.
Ja budem pracovať s vami.
But you have to submit.
Ale vy sa musíte poddať mne.
And you have to do it my way.
A musíte to robiť mojím spôsobom.
And if you want to build your kingdom,
a ak si chcete budovať svoje kráľovstvo,
the Spirit of God is saying, I will build the kingdom.
Duch Svätý hovorí, ja budem budovať kráľovstvo.
It's your choice to be a part in it.
A je to vaše rozhodnutie, či budete jeho súčasťou.
To build your own house on sand.
Alebo si budete budovať svoj vlastný dom na piesku.
The Spirit of God is saying.
A Duch Boží hovorí.
I see something in the region of around 20-30 kilometers from here.
A ja vidím niečo v oblasti 20-30 kilometrov odtiaľto.
It's almost like something what will be interesting for tourists.
Je to niečo, čo je zaujímavé pre turistov.
Where there will be something done or discovered.
Je to niečo, čo je akoby objavené.
Yeah, there will be something discovered.
Niečo tam bude objavené.
And people will come to see it.
A ľudia tam prídu, aby to videli.
The Spirit of God is saying, Church.
A Duch Boží hovorí, cirkev.
This is not the time to play.
Toto nie je čas pre hru.
This is a time to stand firm.
Toto je čas, aby ste stáli pevne.
This is a time to declare the King is alive.
Toto je čas, aby ste vyhlasovali, že král je živý.
This is a time to grow up.
Toto je čas, aby ste vyrástli.
You have everything what you need, the Spirit of God is saying.
Máte všetko, čo potrebujete, hovorí
Duch Boží. The word.
Máte slovo.
And you have the Spirit.
A máte ducha.
It's up to you.
Je to na vás.
Because I can save through many of you, the Spirit of God is saying.
Pretože ja môžem zachraňovať cez mnohých z vás, hovorí Duch Boží.
And I have already prepared my workers in this area.
A ja už som si pripravil mojich pracovníkov v tejto oblasti.
When you see the water rising.
A keď uvidíte tú vodu, ako vyviera.
Even in places where they are surprised, where should the water come from?
Dokonca aj na miesta, kde by sa to neočakávalo.
Then remember.
Tak si spomente.
This is a time of grace for those who submit.
Toto je čas milosti pre tých, ktorí sa podali.
To Almighty God.
Tomu všemohúcemu Bohu.
And resist the devil.
A vzopreli sa Bohu.
This is a time. Diablovi. This is a time for the ones who seek true unity.
Toto je čas pre tých, ktorí hľadajú skutočnú jednotu.
And even when you will go from here.
A dokonca aj keď odídete odtiaľto.
And when my word will go out, the Spirit of God is saying.
A moje slovo odíde.
Some will rise. Some will rise and say, this is not God.
Niektorí povstanú a povedia, toto nie je Boh.
But you know and you can discern, the Spirit of God is saying.
Ale vy to viete a vy to rozlíšite, hovorí Duch Boží.
I'm going to awaken your heart.
Ja idem zobudiť vaše srdcia.
And there will be dreams and visions in the night.
A v noci budete mať sny a videnia.
And it starts already now.
A začína sa to teraz.
As I have sent my son to you, the Spirit of God is saying.
Ako som poslal svojho syna.
To be my mouthpiece and to speak to you.
Aby bol mojimi ústami a hovoril k vám.
I will confirm the words with signs and wonders.
Ja potvrdím to slovo zázrakmi a znameniami.
But lift your hands and worship him in purity.
Ale pozdvihnite svoje ruky a uctievajte ho v čistote.
Because there's an unclean spirit over this area.
Pretože nad týmto touto oblasťou je nečistý duch.
Receive the grace to stand.
Takže dostaňte, príjmite milosť, aby ste obstáli.
Watch your eyes, the Spirit of God is saying.
Sledujte to, čo vidíte.
And I'm not coming to judge you.
Neprichádzam vás súdiť.
I'm coming to strengthen you.
Prichádzam vás posilniť.
Almighty God is building his church.
Všemocný Boh si buduje svoju cirkev.
And he wants you to be a part in it.
A on chce, aby ste boli toho súčasťou.
Father, we thank you with all of our heart.
Otecko, my ti ďakujeme z celého srdca.
Father, we say you will be done in this area.
Otecko, my hovoríme, nech sa tvoja vôľa naplní v tejto oblasti.
Build your kingdom, O God.
Buduj svoje kráľovstvo, Bože.
Release boldness that people are brave.
Uvoľni smelosť, aby ľudia boli smelí.
In Jesus name.
Nebojácni, v mene Ježiš.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Listen, my dear brothers and sisters.
Počujte, moji drahí bratia a sestry.
Oh, let me give a word for her.
Ešte mám to slovo pre vás.
What's your name, sweetheart?
Ako sa voláš, Zlatíčko?
Zlatíčko. What's your name, Zlatíčko? It's nice, sounds nice. Zlatíčko. I learned this, Zlatíčko. What's your name, Zlatíčko? Bojka? Lenka. Oh, good name, Lenka.
Dobré meno.
Zlatíčko. It's right? Zlatíčko. Zlatíčko, right? Kind of, okay. Okay, Lord, help me, Zlatíčko. Do you know the word šnukipuci?
Viete, čo znamená šnukipuci?
You know, Zlatíčko.
Zlatíčko.
Lenka. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the heart of Lenka.
Ďaká ti za Lenkino srdce.
You are truly a peacemaker.
Vy ste, ty si človek, ktorý prináša pokoj.
You are network. Is it the battery or is it too much power of God? The thing flows away.
Príliš veľa Božej moci.
The critics would say, "Oh, this was God."
Kritici povedia, "Ale to bol Boh."
Ah, wonderful. Thank you, Lord.
Ďaká ti, Páne.
Lenka, you know when the father looked at Jesus and he smiled and he said, "This is my beloved son."
Viete, keď otec pozrel na Ježiša, tak sa usmial a povedal, "Toto je môj milovaný syn."
He's smiling at you and saying, "This is my beloved daughter."
A on sa usmieva na teba a hovorí, "Moja milovaná dcérka."
You know, your motivation is often misunderstood from the people.
Tvoja motivácia je často nepochopená ľuďmi.
It's not that you want to move the things or manipulate the things.
Neznamená to, že chceš niečím proste hýbať alebo manipulovať.
You're caring about people.
Ale staráš sa o ľudí.
And this is why sometimes, you know, you try to bring them together.
A snažíš sa ich akoby dať dokopy.
But you had to battle on your own so much.
Ale veľmi často musíš proste bojovať sama.
And the father saying, "I will teach you how to battle in my strength."
A Pán ti hovorí, ja ťa budem učiť, ako bojovať v mojej sile.
I see the father saying, "Today I will lift the burden from you."
A ja cítim, vnímam, ako Pán hovorí, ja zdvihnem to bremeno z teba.
Which you have carried with you for many years.
Ktoré si niesla mnoho rokov.
It's almost like you got used to it.
Je to ako by si si na to už zvykla.
And you had no more hope that it will be changed.
A už nemáš ani nádej, že by sa to mohlo zmeniť.
And the father saying, "It looks sometimes like I come too late."
A otec hovorí, niekedy to vyzerá, že prichádzam neskoro.
But I always come in the right time.
Ale ja vždy prichádzam v pravý čas.
He's saying, "I've seen your tears."
Takže ja som videl tvoje slzy.
And I've seen your heart crying out to me.
A ja som videl tvoje srdce, ako volá ku mne.
And I've heard your heart saying, "How long, O Lord?"
A ja som počul, ako hovoríš, ako ešte dlho, Pane.
And he saw that you were not able to share with others.
A ja som videl, že si nebola schopná to zdieľať s druhými.
Because when you tried, they misunderstood you.
Pretože keď si sa o to snažila, nerozumeli ti.
And the father saying, "I was allowing these things to happen."
Ale otec hovorí, ja som to dovolil.
So that you draw closer to me.
Aby si prišla bližšie ku mne.
And he says, "Well done."
A on hovorí, dobrá práca.
You passed the test. You have not failed.
Prešla si tým testom.
I see how the healing presence of God is coming in your family.
A ja vnímam, ako uzdravujúca prítomnosť prichádza do tvojej rodiny.
And it's not only emotional healing.
A nie je to iba emocionálne uzdravenie.
But it's physical healing.
Ale je to aj fyzické uzdravenie.
And the father saying, "I want you to believe."
A otec hovorí, chcem, aby si verila.
That I can heal through you.
Že ja môžem uzdravovať cez teba.
Because in my eyes.
Pretože v mojich očiach.
You're in the same way holy.
Si takisto svätá.
Like this man is holy.
Ako tento muž je svätý.
Thank you, Lord.
Ďaká ti, Oče.
Father, we love you.
Oče, milujeme ťa.
And you know this it's almost like a confusion who comes sometimes.
Je to niečo ako taký zmetok, také zmetenie, ktoré prichádza niekedy na teba.
You know, and the father is saying, "This will stop. The storm will stop."
Ale Pán hovorí, tá búrka prestane.
And you will be like Jesus resting in the midst of the challenges.
A ty budeš tak ako Ježíš vedieť odpočívať uprostred tých víziev.
So this speaks about a new dimension of faith.
Takže hovorí to o novej dimenzii viery.
This speaks about seeing things from a different perspective.
Hovorí to o tom vidieť veci z inej perspektívy.
So Father, we bless your daughter.
Takže Oče, my žehnáme tvoju dcéru.
And we release dignity.
A my uvoľňujeme dôstojnosť.
And this passion she carried once in her for you.
A tú vášeň, ktorá ona kedysi mala pre teba.
You tried too long to fit in the box.
Príliš dlho si sa snažila vtesnať sa do tej krabice.
And you're not called to be someone what others expect from you.
Ale ty nie si povolaná, aby si bola niekým, čo druhí očakávajú od teba.
Because he made you special and the world needs you.
Pretože ty si špeciálna a svet potrebuje teba.
And something else.
A ešte niečo?
It's good to do things for others.
Je dobré robiť veci pre druhých.
But sometimes you need to do good things to yourself.
Ale niekedy potrebuješ robiť dobré veci aj pre seba.
It's also a sign that we love ourselves.
A je to znamením, že milujeme aj samých seba.
And you have been harder with yourself than your father is with you.
A ty si bývala tvrdšia na seba ako tvoj otec nebeský je na teba.
Don't beat yourself up when you think you're not holy enough.
Takže keď sa ti zdá, že nie si dosť svätá, tak sa nebi za to.
Don't see yourself so low.
Nevidí sa tak nízko.
And I don't know if it's symbolically or if it really happens.
A neviem, či je to teraz symbolické, alebo sa to skutočne stalo.
I see strength coming in your knees.
Vidím silu prichádzať do tvojich kolien.
And I think it's also a meaning that you will stand firm.
Ale ja vnímam, že to môže znamenať, že budeš stáť pevne.
Again, speaks about faith from God.
Znova to hovorí o viere od Boha.
Thank you, Father.
Ďaká ti, Otče.
You know, someone who got a whole... Is it a whole set, Lord, or is there one thing? You know, when you have these knives and forks and the different things, you know, and it's something what you got from your grandma's side, you know, you have this whole set with knives and forks.
Takže keď máme niekedy od našich starých maminiek také tie príborníky.
But I saw one of them is like bent.
Ale ja som videl, akoby jeden z tých príborov bol ohnutý.
And I have no idea what happened.
Vôbec netuším, čo sa stalo.
I hope you were not sitting there and trying like, you know, to bend it with your mind.
Myslím, že...
I don't understand. I said, I hope you were not sitting there and trying to bend the fork with your knife.
Že dúfam, že ste sa nesnažili proste svojou myslou to akože teraz ten, tú vidličku ako zlomiť.
So forget it. It was a joke. It didn't work. But this is something you got from your grandma.
Ale je to niečo, čo ste dostali od svojej starej mamy.
And it almost looked like on the end there is something eingraviert.
A zdá sa, že na konci je niečo vygravírované.
You know, so it has something to do with your grandma's side. And,
takže niečo sa to týka proste vašich starých rodičov, starej maminky.
And it could be that in this surrounding the name Kata or that Kačka means something to you?
Má to niečo s menom Kata alebo Kačka? Kačka. Katka.
Oh, so tired. Baby is tired.
Deti sú unavené. Pane, je tam niečo viac?
The strange thing is,
zaujímavá vec je, zvláštna.
It almost looks like even the fork who is bent has a different color than the others.
Zdá sa, ako by tá ohnutá vidlička mala inú farbu ako tie ostatné.
And so it could be that there was once a whole set there and the fork is the only thing what is left. You know, it could be that there was once a whole set there.
Zdá sa, že kedysi to bol celistvý,
ten set. But the fork is the one who is left now. And it's from your grandmother.
Ale chýba tam akoby tá vidlička. Dostali ste to od svojej starej mamy.
It has a meaning to you. Personal family meaning.
Niečo to pre vás znamená, pre vás osobne.
And I think that either you or this side of the family had something to do with antiques.
Antiques.
Mm-hmm.
Myslím si, že niečo máte dočinenia, alebo skrátka sa to týka starožitníctva.
And does the fork mean something to you?
A niečo pre vás znamená tá vidlička?
I used to do this.
Oh, you used to bend them.
God, zvykli ste to it. Ohýbať. Boh to videl.
I don't know if it's a sin.
Yeah.
We did it.
Yeah, so was it from at home or was it from antiques she had what you were bending?
Bolo to starožitné?
Yeah. A byly tam všechny možný. My jsme jich vohnuli více.
Many of them, yeah. That's maybe why I saw first many of them, then I saw one. You know, do you have any idea, your mom and your grandma, was there some, is there something?
Něco vám to
hovorí s maminkou? My s mužem jsme dostali jako příborník, to je pravda, ke svatbě, a o něj jsme jako, my jsme o všechno jako přišli, i s tím příborníkem. A pak jsme začali dělat teprve starožitnosti, když jsme o všechno přišli.
Yeah. So when you got married, you got a set, yeah?
Yes. Od maminky, od staré maminky.
Od babičky.
Yes. From grandmother.
From grandmother. Yes. And your mom did with antiques. And then and then you lost everything.
And then we started to do antiques.
Yeah. Okay. Now I understand.
Tak teraz tomu rozumím.
Okay. There have been, you know, there is. This is why I saw the fork in gold.
Preto som videl tú lyžičku zlatú.
Gold is a symbol of wealth.
Zlato je symbolom bohatstva.
And there have been a line in your family where the Lord has put his blessing for wealth, but the enemy, like you said, mm-hmm. came in and destroyed.
Vo vašej rodine bola proste línia akoby bohatstva, ale proste prišiel nepriateľ a
and he wants to destroy.
No, and the devil came in and was able to stop this flow of wealth.
Ale diabol prišiel a bol schopný proste zastaviť ten tok toho bohatstva.
And even now the flow is not really released in the fullness as God wants.
A aj teraz vlastne ešte ten tok toho bohatstva nie je plne akoby uvoľnený.
But in the name of Jesus.
Ale v mene Ježíš.
Thank you Father that I can declare.
Ďaká Oče, že to je jasné teraz.
That everything that was holding back this flow.
Že všetko, čo zadržiavalo ten tok.
Is broken now in the name of Jesus.
Je zlomené teraz v mene Ježíš.
And there is a great anointing upon you to make money.
A je veľké pomazanie na tebe robiť vyrábať peniaze.
Will you be my friend?
Mohla by si sa stať mojím priateľom?
When you have prophecies like this, you need to become friends.
Keď sú takéto proroctvá, tak chceme byť kamaráti.
And Father, we release this in your name.
Oče, my to uvoľňujeme v tvojom mene.
You know there is business ideas upon you.
Sú máš také biznis nápady.
And the Lord will teach you to channel it in the right direction.
A Pán ťa bude učiť ako
to release this mm-hmm. gift in the right direction.
Proste ten dar uvoľniť správnym smerom.
Because you can see something and you see the potential in it.
Pretože ty niečo vidíš potenciál v niečom.
And then you see the other thing and you see the potential in it.
A potom zrazu niečo iné vidíš a tiež vidíš ten
potenciál. And you will learn to focus.
A ty sa naučíš zamerať sa.
And then the breakthrough will come.
The
But I want you to know that there is anointing on your family to make money.
Ale chcem, aby si vedela, že na tvojej rodine je pomazanie vyrábať peniaze.
So and we release it now in Jesus' name.
Takže my to teraz uvoľňujeme v mene Ježiš.
A constant increase.
Neustály rast.
And you guys will be involved in setting houses up for children who have learning difficulties.
A vy budete akoby súčasťou niečoho, čo bude budovať domy pre detičky, ktoré majú nejaké problémy.
And to do this and orphans.
Siroty.
And to do this the Lord will give you a lot of money.
A k tomuto vám Pán požehná veľa peňazí.
So that you can employ people.
Aby ste mohli zamestnať ľudí.
That you can support people.
Aby ste mohli podporiť ľudí.
Because the greatest anointing will be always in business and making money.
Pretože vždy to najväčšie pomazanie bude v tom biznise a v tom zarábaní peňazí.
And the Lord encourages you.
A Pán ťa pozdvihuje,
povzbudzuje. To think outside the box.
Aby si myslela mimo tej krabice.
You know what? And the Father.
A otec.
He loves your cheekiness. Cheeky. When someone is cheeky, a little bit. Sorry? Cheekiness.
What do you mean, cheekiness?
When someone is cheeky, you know he is.
Drzí. Proste otec ťa miluje.
He loves your cheekiness? Yeah.
Aha, takže Boh miluje takú tvoju,
you know,
tvoju drzosť.
It's like if a door is closed.
Proste keď sú niekde dvere zatvorené.
And people say you can't go through this door.
A ľudia povedia, tady to nesmiete prejsť.
She will go around the corner and find another way.
Tak ona pôjde za roh a nájde inú cestu.
And you will not give up.
A nevzdáš sa.
What people thought sometimes that it is stubbornness. People thought it's stubbornness.
Ľudia si niekedy myslia, že to je tvrdohlavosť.
But God has given you a strong will.
Ale Boh ti dal takú pevnú vôľu.
You only have to use it in the right way.
Okay.
Yeah. What did you get?
I started to listen.
Yeah. No, God has given you a strong will.
Mm-hmm. Boh ti dal takú pevnú vôľu.
And you will use it for the kingdom.
A budeš to používať pre kráľovstvo.
And you will encourage many young women.
A budeš povzbudzovať mnohé mladé ženy.
And you will reach the young women outside the church.
A budeš zasahovať ženy mimo cirkvi.
Women who have to do with cosmetics and different stuff.
Ženy, ktoré majú niečo s kozmetikou.
Who have cosmetic salons and going on sunbeds and things like this, and you will be there will come a time you have a lot of these women around you.
Solárka, bude čas, keď bude veľa takýchto žien okolo teba.
Some models.
Nejaké modelky.
Yeah, no, you. How is that? God will open your doors to these people.
Boh ti otvorí dvere k týmto ľuďom.
And you will be able to share the love of Christ with them.
A budeš schopná sa s nimi zdieľať o Božej láske.
And you know what? God is not interested on that dress code. God is not interested the way they wear dress.
A Boha nezaujíma to, ako človek chodí oblečený.
He's interested in the heart.
Ale zaujíma ho srdce človeka.
So when people then come and say, how can you speak with such women?
A keď niekto ti povie, ako sa môžeš rozprávať s takými ženami?
Remember that Jesus was called the friend of sinners.
Spomeň si, že Ježiš bol tiež nazvaný priateľom hriešnikov.
And he also went to people where the others didn't go.
A pôjdeš, aj on išiel.
He went to people where others
chodil,
didn't go.
At
the same way, she will go to people which the church will not go.
Takže tak ako Ježiš chodil za ľuďmi, za ktorými nikto iný nešiel, takisto aj ty budeš chodiť k ľuďom, ku ktorými cirkev nejde.
But you have to stop to limit yourself here.
Ale musíš sa zastaviť, aby si... A musíš sa prestať limitovať.
It's sebe. You know, it's she takes so long already, you know. I'm always taking a long of time. She's good. You know, it's difficult as you translate more. Thank you, God. Okay, let me do one thing.
Dovolte mi urobiť jednu vec.
Because we have tomorrow again meetings.
Lebo aj zajtra máme.
And I will always step out and minister in the prophetic.
A ja vždy proste vykročím a slúžim prorockým darom.
I want to tell you one thing.
Chcem vám povedať jednu vec.
One of the first things the devil will attack some of you when you go from here.
Jedna z prvých vecí, ktorou vás diabol napadne, keď odtiaľto odídete.
He will tell you.
On vám povie.
This can't be from God, he's a fortune teller.
To nemôže byť od Boha. On je jasnovidec alebo veštec.
This is from his past.
To je z jeho minulosti.
And you know what is a sad thing? What is a sad thing?
Čo je smutná vec?
Some people believe that fortune tellers can do this.
Niektorí ľudia veria, že jasnovidci to môžu robiť.
But they don't believe that people who have the Holy Spirit can do this.
Ale neveria, že to môžu robiť ľudia, ktorí majú Ducha Svätého.
This makes God so small and the devil so big.
A toto robí z Boha takého malinkého a diabla takého veľkého.
And if you listen to your heart,
a ak počúvate svoje srdce,
you felt if this was the love of the Father or if it was not the love.
Tak ste proste vnímali, cítili ste, či je to Otcova láska alebo nie.
You know, we love the church.
My milujeme cirkev.
And we are part of the church, all of us.
A sme súčasťou cirkvi všetci.
And we love and respect leadership who is being called from God.
A milujeme a ctíme si vodcovstvo, ktoré je od Boha.
But in the first place you are responsible before God and the word of God.
Ale v prvom rade ste zodpovední pred Božím slovom.
You have to search yourself.
Musíte sa sami seba skúmať.
You have to study yourself.
Musíte sa študovať.
You can't say one day, but God, my pastor said this and this and this.
Nemôžete raz prísť pred Boha a povedať, ale Bože, môj pastor povedal tak a
say, but you had my word.
On povie, mal si moje slovo.
And you had my Holy Spirit.
A mal si môjho ducha.
Why did you not look by yourself?
Prečo si to
I am a man like I'm a person like you.
Ja som ako vy.
And
človek ako vy.
It's grace who works through me.
A je to milosť, ktorá pracuje cez mňa.
And I'm not perfect.
A nie som dokonalý.
And I try my best to get the interpretation so clear as I can.
A snažím sa, aby bolo schopné to pretlmočiť čo najjednoduchšie.
But I'm not claiming that I'm all the time right.
Ale nevyhlasujem, že vždy hovorím všetko správne.
And I will never tell you who you shall marry.
A nikdy vám nepoviem, koho si máte vziať.
Because I believe God can do this better.
Lebo verím, že Boh to vie urobiť lepšie.
I will never tell you that you shall move tomorrow to Africa.
A nikdy vám nepoviem, že zajtra sa máte odsťahovať do Afriky.
Because God can do this better.
Pretože to Boh vie urobiť lepšie.
And I will never tell you you have to do now what I said.
A nikdy vám nehovorím, musíte urobiť to, čo vám teraz hovorím.
Because you have to test it.
Lebo máte to testovať, máte to.
You have to ask God the Father.
Rozsúdiť. Máte sa opýtať Otca.
This is a confirmation for what you already had.
A musíte to vnímať, či je to také potvrdenie vo vás.
Some things you wait if they come like this. For some things you have to wait.
Na niektoré veci musíte počkať.
But the most important, the greatest miracle.
Ale najdôležitejšie je ten najväčší zázrak.
Is if you experience and know the Father.
Je, keď zažijete a poznáte Otca.
I would give every gift, every spiritual gift I would put on the side if I had to choose between knowing him or the gift.
Ak si môžem vybrať medzi tým poznať jeho a nejaké dary, tak tie dary proste idú úplne stranou.
Because the gift can touch you now.
Pretože ten dar sa vás teraz môže dotknúť.
The Father makes you strong in daily life.
Ale Otec vás činí silnými dennodenne, v každodennom živote.
And tomorrow we talk more about this.
A zajtra o tom budeme hovoriť viac.
And also how we can get to know him more.
A ešte ako ho môžeme viac poznať.
But I hope you felt a little bit his heart tonight.
Ale dúfam, že ste aspoň trochu pocítili jeho srdce dnes večer.
And I hope I could show you a way of ministry which does good to you and not force you or do anything.
A dúfam, že vám môžem ukázať taký druh služby, ktorý vám môže pomôcť, poslúžiť a
and
urobiť dobre.
You have now a greater desire to get to know him through the Holy Spirit.
A dúfam, že máte teraz väčšiu túžbu poznať ho viac skrze Ducha Svätého.
Because he's really a good, good father.
Lebo on je naozaj dobrý, dobrý otec.
But it's not easy.
Ale nie je to
ľahké. To walk and to live for him.
Chodiť s ním a žiť pre neho.
Because if you do it, a lot of things will be against you.
Lebo ak nastúpite taký život, mnohé veci povstanú proti vám.
And the most hurtful are the religious spirits.
A hlavne to budú náboženskí duchovia.
Who attack you in the name of God.
Ktorí vás budú v mene Boha napádať.
Always forgive. Always forgive.
Vždy odpustite.
And go to the Father.
A choďte k Otcovi.
He can protect your heart.
On môže ochrániť vaše srdce.
And he helps you to remember.
A bude pomôže vám pamätať si.
They don't know what they do.
Oni nevedia, čo robia.
Or they don't know God.
Alebo nepoznajú Boha.
Because if they would know him.
Pretože ak by ho poznali.
They would not do it to you.
Tak by vám to nerobili.
So Father, I pray that each person.
Takže Otče, ja každú osobu tu.
Whenever you want.
Dávam tebe. Čokoľvek ty chceš.
Will have a personal experience with you.
Ja prosím, aby mal každý človek osobnú skúsenosť s tebou.
Father, these are your children.
Otče, toto sú tvoje deti.
Please heal them.
Prosím, uzdrav ich.
Please end their pain. End their pain.
Ukonči ich bolesť.
Restore the families.
Uzdrav rodiny, obnov.
Release them from addictions.
Uvoľni ich z poviazaní závislosti.
Show us your grace.
Ukáž nám svoju milosť.
And bind us together, Father.
A spoj nás dohromady, Pane.
In love.
Otče, v láske.
Because we are your children.
Lebo my sme tvoje deti.
And even if they go home tonight.
A aj keď pôjdeme domov dnes večer.
Father, I ask you in the name of Jesus.
Otče, ja ťa prosím v mene Ježiš.
Show them signs of love.
Ukáž im také znamenie lásky.
I know you don't have to do it.
Ja viem, že to nemusíš robiť.
But I ask you for your children here.
Ale ja ťa prosím za tvoje deti dnes.
Whatever ways.
Jakýmkoľvek spôsobom.
Show them.
Ukáž.
As you said, you will confirm your word.
Lebo si povedal, že potvrdíš svoje slovo.
As I prayed.
A ako som sa modlil.
There's from three people migraine you had for many years are gone.
Sú tu traja ľudia, ktorí po mnohé roky mávali migrénu a odišla, je preč.
Who is this person who sometimes in the night wakes up screaming?
Kto z vás je tu, ktorý sa niekedy v noci zobudí a kričí?
person who picks up strawberries. Could be someone of your family members.
Alebo niekto z vašich príbuzných.
Is that you? Is you? You sometimes wake up and screaming?
Niekedy sa prebudíte s krikom v noci?
Yeah. Okay. Father, we thank you that this ends now.
Oče, my ti ďakujeme, že toto sa skončilo teraz.
She is your daughter.
Ona je tvoja dcéra.
And she deserves to sleep in peace.
A jej patrí pokojný spánok.
And the word of God says.
A Božie slovo hovorí.
When I lie down,
keď ja si lahnem,
I will rest in peace.
Tak budem odpočívať v pokoji.
Because you are God with me.
Pretože ty, Bože, si so mnou.
Your God is with you.
Tvoj Boh je s tebou.
The Father is opening up a new door for you.
A Otec ti otvára nové dvere teraz.
Even if it looks in the moment like you're stuck.
Hoci sa ti teraz zdá, že si akoby zastavená.
And things are not moving.
A veci sa nehýbu.
And even some people think it's because God is angry with you.
A možno niektorí ľudia si myslia, že Boh je na teba naštvaný.
He's opening up a door.
Ale on otvára dvere
pre teba.
Something
new what you're going to do.
Je niečo nové, čo budeš robiť.
And this time there will be the right people around you.
A príde čas, keď budú správni ľudia okolo teba.
Who encourage you and will show you the appreciation you deserve.
Ktorí ťa povzbudia a show you
appreciation. Show you the appreciation that someone is.
Mm-hmm. A ukážu ti to tú takú tú vzácnosť.
You had to move on.
Potrebuješ ísť dopredu, hýbať sa.
So that you can survive.
Aby si mohla prežiť.
Because the Lord saw this strong battle around you.
Lebo Pán videl ten silný boj okolo teba.
You know, you learned to be strong.
Ty si sa naučila byť silnou.
But the father saying, daughter,
ale otec ti hovorí, dcéra,
I don't want you to hope for the good.
Ja nechcem, aby si dúfala v dobré.
I want you to expect the best.
Ja chcem, aby si očakávala to najlepšie.
Because you're worthy.
Lebo si hodná.
You always settle with so less. So you settle with so less, you know.
Ty si sa vždy usadila akoby na tom mále. Si sa uspokojila s tým málom.
And the father is saying, daughter,
ale otec ti hovorí, dcéra,
I will change it.
Ja to zmením.
From why is this always happening to me? I will change it from the saying why is it always happening to me?
Ja to zmením z takého toho stavu, prečo sa to stále deje mne?
To thank you God that you bless me all the time.
Na to ďakujem ti Bože, že mi stále žehnáš.
There's a shift in the moment in your life.
Teraz prichádza taká zmena v tvojom živote, taký presun.
Don't look back anymore.
Už sa nepozeraj dozadu.
And don't let the people of destruction back in your life from the past.
A nedovol, aby sa ľudia, ktorí ťa ničili, vrátili znovu do tvojho života.
Because it moved you forward. And you would sleep.
Pretože proste to ťa pohne dopredu a budeš dobre spať.
Okay, if you love Jesus and you think that he is really good and cool.
Ak milujete Ježiša, myslíte si, že je naozaj skvelý?
What means cool in Czech?
Cool.
Is you have the same word, he's really.
Čo znamená hip, cool? Skvelý, super.
He's really good.
Bezvadný.
You know? Then you can say amen or yo man or yes brother.
Môžete povedať amen alebo
or hallelujah.
Jo Bože.
Okay, it was a good start tonight.
To bol dobrý začiatok dnes večer.
Please tell us tomorrow when you realize that things have happened to you.
A zajtra nám prosím povedzte, keď si uvedomíte, že niečo sa s vami stalo, udialo.
A lot of more things happened.
Lebo sa stalo viac vecí.
You know, someone with a very strong skin allergy got touched you tonight.
Niekoho sa Boh dotkol, kto mal veľmi silnú alergiu na koži.
When it comes, you scratch like wild, God healed you tonight. When it comes, the allergy, you stretch like
bolo to,
wild.
Bolo to veľmi, keď sa to proste, keď to prišlo, tá alergia, tak to strašne svrbelo. Boh vás uzdravuje dnes večer.
You know, and a diagnose from doctors about your bladder. Some diagnosis from doctors about the bladder.
What is bladder?
Bladder is the thing where the wee comes out.
Aha, niekto má problém s močovým mechúrom.
You know, you got a diagnosis from the doctor.
Dostali ste nejakú diagnózu od doktorov.
You know, there's one person you are afraid about cancer.
A niekto z vás sa tu bojí rakoviny.
It's almost like there is a little thing growing on your body.
Zdá sa vám, že niečo malinké vám rastie na tele alebo v tele.
If it goes in the next 3 days, don't be afraid.
Do 3 dní to odíde, nebojte sa.
Say thank you to God for healing.
Povedzte vďaka ti Bože za uzdravenie.
And you will see it.
Uvidíte to.
Are there some leaders here tonight?
Sú tu dnes nejakí vedúci?
If you're a leader in the church, can you stand up please for a moment?
Ak si vedúci nejakého zboru, nejakej cirkvi, môžeš sa postaviť, prosím? Na moment.
Yeah. Okay. Father, I pray for your leaders.
Oče, ja sa modlím za vedúcich.
And I pray that you will encourage them.
Ja sa modlím, aby si ich povzbudil, aby si ich posilnil.
And we thank you so much for people who dedicate their life to serve you.
A vďaka ti, veľká vďaka za ľudí, ktorí vydali svoj život,
Father, we pray
aby ti slúžili.
That you give helper on their side.
Oče, my sa modlíme, aby si dal pomocníkov týmto ľuďom. Ľudí, ktorí pozdvihnú ich, pomôžu ich rodinám. Ktorých proste budú povzbudzovať.
But most of all we pray,
ale najviac zo všetkého sa modlíme.
Holy Spirit will lead and guide them.
Aby Duch Svätý ich viedol.
And that they can see what you see.
A aby oni videli to, čo ty vidíš.
We pray that they will come in the fullness of reflecting you as a father.
A my sa modlíme, aby oni vstúpili do plnosti toho, aby ukazovali to, kto ty si, Oče.
So when the church looks at them.
Aby cirkev sa pozrie na nich.
That they will see, we see a part of the Father in heaven in you.
Aby videli takú časť Otca nebeského vo vás.
So you bless you in the name of Jesus.
Takže vás žehnáme v mene Ježiš.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for your service.
Ďakujem vám za vašu službu.
In the church. Okay,
cirkvi.
Young man.
Mladý muž.
Okay. Translate. Is your wife here?
Je tu tvoja žena?
You know, come here. You know, us we are Christians.
Viete, my ako kresťania?
And we live already with our heart in eternity.
My ako kresťania žijeme už akoby s našim srdcom vo večnosti.
We are not concerned about time.
Takže nerozmýšľame nad časom.
Amen. Some.
Niekedy.
Okay, no, I let you go.
Niektorí.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ďaká ti, Ježiš.
I want to tell you something, guys.
Chcem vám niečo povedať.
And I'm really honest with you.
Som veľmi úprimný k vám.
I know a little bit about his story, more than you.
Troška niečo viem o jeho príbehu.
But not from God, because he told me.
Ale nie od Boha, on mi to sám povedal, porozprával.
But you know, when he contacted me,
ale viete, keď ma on kontaktoval,
I'm very careful where I'm going.
Ja dávam pozor na to, kam idem.
But the Lord said to me, I want you to go to him.
Ale Pán mi povedal, chcem, aby si tam išiel.
But when the time is right.
Ale vtedy, keď príde čas.
That's why he had to wait a little bit before I came.
To je ten dôvod, prečo musel trocha čakať.
And I really want to honor him here before you guys.
A chcel by som ho teraz pred vami si tak úctiť.
And I want to tell you, they both have a heart who loves Jesus.
A chcem povedať, že oni obaja majú srdce, ktoré miluje Ježiša.
And they both are called from God.
A obaja sú povolaní od Boha.
And I'm not getting paid to say this.
A nedostanem za toto peniaze, že som to povedal.
You know, and I'm not saying this to everyone.
Sorry.
And I'm not saying this to everyone.
A nehovorím to každému.
But I feel like to stand with them and to declare this also in the spiritual world.
Ale ja vnímam, že by som mal ich akoby vyhlásiť v duchovnom svete.
Because if you set up like this.
Pretože keď vytvoríte niečo takéto, ako je tu dnes.
The devil hates it.
A diabol to nenávidí.
The devil hates the prophetic.
Diabol nenávidí proroctvo.
Because it brings life to the people.
Pretože to prináša život ľuďom.
And it stirs something up in your heart for the Lord.
A niečo to vo vašom srdci vypôsobí k Pánovi.
And he will always attack the people who open the door for the prophetic.
A on vždy bude napádať ľudí, ktorí sú otvorení proroctvu.
Because I'm going again. I'm going again.
Pretože ja znova odídem.
But he will stay here with the trouble.
Ale oni tu ostanú s tými problémami.
So I want you to pray for him.
Takže sa chcem modliť za ňo.
That they have wisdom for the things to come.
Aby mali múdrosť v tých veciach, ktoré prídu.
That God makes them brave to do what he wants them to do.
Aby ich Boh posilnil a urobil smelými, aby vykonali to, čo majú.
That the right people come around them.
Aby prišli správni ľudia do ich blízkosti.
And I hear the Spirit of God saying, son and daughter.
A vnímam Ducha Svätého, ako hovorí syn a dcéra.
Yes, you're right. You have seen the darkness.
Máte pravdu, viděli jste temnotu.
And like Joseph was dreaming a big dream.
A tak jako Josef mal velký sen.
But then his whole life collapsed.
Ale potom celý jeho život skolaboval.
And he went in slavery and in darkness.
A odišel do otroctva a do temnoty.
You have seen the darkness.
Vy jste tiež viděli temnotu.
And the confusion.
A zmetok.
And as the voice of death have been close to you.
A tak jako ten hlas smrti bol blízko vám.
The Spirit of God is saying.
Duch svätý hovorí.
My hand was not too short to deliver you.
Moja ruka nebola krátka, aby vás zachránila.
And I showed you the deep depths of the darkness.
A ja som vám ukázal tú hĺbku tej temnoty.
So that you will appreciate and love the light.
Aby ste si vážili tento svetlo.
And the Father saying, son.
A otec hovorí synu.
Not a second time will come destruction to your house.
Druhýkrát už nepríde zničenie do tvojho domu.
Don't even think a second about it.
Ani na sekundu si na to nepomyslí.
The shadows of the past are gone.
Tie tiene minulosti sú preč.
The tunnel is finished. You are through the tunnel.
Ten tunel je na konci.
And
prešli
it's the light is shining now.
A teraz svieti svetlo.
And I have built a foundation in this time in you.
A ja som v tomto čase budoval základ vo vás,
so that you can stand together,
aby ste vedeli stať spolu
and create a place,
a vytvoriť miesto,
where people experience the mercy and the goodness of the Father.
Kde ľudia môžu zažiť milosť a lásku Otca.
And when the religious spirits were raised against you,
a keď náboženskí duchovia povstali proti
then
vám,
remember the battle belongs to
alebo povstanú proti vám. Pamätajte si, že tento boj patrí Pánovi.
Don't go through their tables when they call you to discuss.
Nechoďte, aby ste si sadli s nimi za stôl, keď budú chcieť s vami diskutovať.
And don't be concerned about your reputation.
A netrápte sa o vašu povesť.
Because I brought you to this place.
Pretože ja som vás priviedol do tejto oblasti.
So that you fear me more than anyone else, Lord is saying.
Aby ste sa báli mňa viac ako kohokoľvek iného.
And the Father saying, daughter.
A otec hovorí, dcérka.
You will not only be on his side and watch.
Ty nebudeš iba ten pozorujúci.
And you will not say in your heart, oh, I support him and he shall do it.
Nebudeš vo svojom srdci hovoriť iba to, ja ho podporím a on to spraví, on to
you
vykoná.
Both will walk together.
Vy obaja budete kráčať spolu.
And there will be a strong deliverance anointing upon you.
A bude na tebe veľmi silné pomazanie k vyslobodeniu.
And the demons will be afraid of you.
A démoni sa ťa budú báť.
And I release the prophetic eyes in you.
A ja uvoľňujem taký prorocký zrak
I release
v tebe.
The seer eyes.
Ja uvoľňujem taký ten zrak toho vidoucího.
To see like the prophets of old.
Aby si videla ako proroci od dávni proroci.
But to speak like the prophets of the new covenant.
Ale aby si hovorila ako proroci novej zmluvy.
And Father, I thank you that both will be always there will be always someone who is close to the people.
A Oče, ja ti ďakujem za to, že oni obaja sú tí, ktorí budú vždy blízko ľuďom.
And I will do wonderful things for you, the Spirit of God is saying.
A mám nádherné veci pre vás, hovorí Duch Boží.
And people will say, how can you use them?
A ľudia povedia, ako si mohol použiť ich?
And the Father is saying, I'm the one who chooses and I'm the one who calls.
A otec hovorí, ja som ten, ktorý vyberá a ja som ten, ktorý povoláva.
I have to explain to no one.
Ja to nemusím vysvetľovať nikomu.
So Father, we pray.
Takže Otče, my sa modlíme.
For wisdom.
Za múdrosť.
For love.
Za lásku.
To understand the times and the seasons.
Aby porozumeli časom a dobám.
And we pray for people, a team around them.
A my sa modlíme za ľudí a tím okolo nich.
In Jesus name.
Mene Ježiš.
And this will be not the last thing what you organize.
Toto nie je posledná vec, ktorú ste zorganizovali.
There will be bigger things even for young people.
Budú tu väčšie veci, hlavne pre mladých ľudí.
And I see a concert.
Vidím koncerty.
And young people in the freedom of the spirit.
A mladých ľudí v slobode ducha.
And people will say he is deceiving our young people.
A ľudia budú hovoriť, on podvádza našich mladých ľudí.
And then the Lord is saying, look in their eyes.
Ale Pán povie, look in.
Look in the eyes of these young people.
Ale Pán povie, pozrite sa do očí týchto mladých ľudí.
They are alive again.
Oni sú znova živé.
Because the Spirit of God is saying,
pretože Duch Boží hovorí,
Almighty.
Najvyšší.
Is not a dead God.
Nie je mŕtvy Boh.
He is alive.
On je živý.
And he's worthy to be celebrated and to be praised.
A on je hoden, aby bol chválený a uctievaný.
With all of our strength.
Celou našou silou.
With all of our might.
A celou našou mocou.
With all of our heart.
Celým naším srdcom.
I will drive out the spirit of God is saying the boringness in my church.
Ja proste odstránim tú nudu, znudenosť z mojej cirkvi.
And the worship who stinks in my nose.
A to uctievanie, ktoré mi smrdí v nose.
And I will release fresh worship from heaven.
A ja uvoľním čerstvú chválu z neba.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you God. Yes. Okay, thank you so much guys. Sleep well.
Ďaká, veľká vďaka priatelia.
And thank you that you have been nice to me.
A ďakujem, že ste boli na mňa milí.
Thank you very much.